And all right, let's get this party started here. Running a little bit behind here, so I'm going to try and get this chat window up as fast as I possibly can. We are starting a new game here. We have just created our character, and we're, well, right here. Here we are. So while this is going, I will set my chat window up, and hopefully this will be entertaining. Wolf, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Wow, that was quick, man.
Stormcloak.
I'm here getting ready here, trying to get this all set up so I can do the thing here. Usurp his throne. Roach, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream.
You started this war, plunged Skyrim into chaos, and now the Empire is going to put you down.
Mr.
And Krabby
here.
The peace.
Okay, let me do a test here. Okay, perfect. What was that?
It's nothing. Carry on.
So how y'all doing this evening? We're gonna go back some years here and journey back to Tamriel, to Aetherius.
Blessings of the eight divines.
Oh, just shut up and get on with it.
Talos, shut up and let's get this over.
As you wish.
As you wish. That's Walandria.
I haven't got all morning.
Like you got an appointment with death, dude. What are you talking about here? Dearest, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream.
My ancestors are smiling at the Imperials. Can you say the same?
No, I can't say the same, dude. Alright, got a little technical difficulty. I got some tangled-ass cords here, so I gotta untangle this crap before we can get do this thing here. So, alright, and click.
Justice.
Oh, no! Waldabar, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. You just bought the game, haven't played it ever? Okay. Well, then you better cut out and roll it right now, man, because it's gonna be spoilers right away. It hits you right up front with what's going on.
Did you hear that?
No major spoilers in the first part, though.
Prisoner.
To the block, prisoner.
All right, let's see. To the block, prisoner. I do like the way the Elder Scrolls games always start with you as a prisoner, though. I don't know why it cracks me up. Nice and consistent, though. Yeah, it's Waldabar. It is probably, if not my favorite game, it is in the top three. It's
what in oblivion
is that?
Centuries. What do you see?
What do you see? Nothing, Desdemona. He's up. He's like, hey guys, what's up? All right, Roach, no problem, man. We will be here for the next 2 or 3 hours, probably. So you have time. You have time. Now this is, of course, vanilla. I haven't used any mods here at all. And let's go, baby. Let's go. In we go. Get in here. You got to admire Ulfric, man. He slipped his bonds, got rid of his muzzle and everything really quick.
Legends don't burn down villages.
Dude, I would suggest you play it. Just try it.
We need
try
to
it,
now.
Try it unmodded first. And then once you figure out what you like and don't like, you'll have a better idea what mod you would. Oh! Yahoo! That's barbecue! Oh my goodness, it's on fire. But yeah, if you have to use mods, for a vanilla playthrough, I would really recommend.
On the other side. Jump through the roof and keep going.
Why is it not giving me. There it is. Okay. It was, you want to get the unofficial patch, for sure. That one, I cannot recommend that enough. It fixes so much stuff.
No!
See how far, whatever. Going through. Oh, Jesus, no. Get away from me. Bye. What's up, dude? How you doing? Can I borrow a septum? No? Okay, cool. I understand you're busy. Yeah, he's a. I like that they're throwing fireballs at him. It's like he's a dragon, he's breathing fire. Do you think he might be kind of immune to that? I don't know, just technicalities. Definitely want to get the unofficial patch, though. I wouldn't do any game-altering mods until you've got a handle on it. How does it move so fast? Dude, it's a dragon and has wings. Now, how did you get to go through there and I didn't?
You're not stopping us this time. Fine, I hope that dragon takes you all to Sovereign Guard.
Okay, so you have a choice here at the beginning. You can go with the Imperial guy. What the hell? Oh, the Stormcloak. And, or you can go with the Stormcloak guy. Now, I always go with. I've gone with both of them, but I prefer to go with the. I want to pick up this arrow, damn it.
I can cut you loose.
I want to. I always go with him because that way the enemies are the Imperials and they have better loot. Yes, Weldbar, the unofficial patch does exactly that. And it, I mean, they've been working on this since forever, man. All right, man. Enjoy the game. Start playing so you can come and hang out and we can share stories. What's up, man?
Looks like we're the only ones who made it.
Yes.
That thing was a dragon, no doubt. Just like the children's stories and the legends. The harbingers of the end times. We better get moving.
Nice clock.
Come here. Let me see if I can get those bindings off.
It's like, dude, my hands are tied and you gotta pull a knife on me.
You may as well take Gunyar's gear. He won't be needing it anymore.
Okay, so it's... I cannot wait. Okay, so third person is the left bumper.
Gunyar isn't coming back from the dead.
A is activate, B is
take
this,
his armor and anything
Y
else
is jump,
on him.
And X is... Okay, X is weapons. Okay, so it's pretty much Fallout style. I got it, dude. Let's search. And equip. Just gonna take it off.
Alright, get that armor on. Give that axe a few swings.
I'm gonna whack some imperials. And the stealth, I forgot how fast you move when you're sneaking in this game. Look at this, man.
Gate.
Turbo mode! Woohoo! So, yeah. Let's see how much I remember. I haven't played this game in. I was looking at my old save files, and the last time I started it was in August of last year, and then I stopped playing in January. So, I haven't played this game in 7 months. Yeah, 8 months now. So, let's see how much I remember. A 7-year-old game. Come on.
Imperial dogs!
Everybody out! Whack! My stamina's low. That's fine, whatever.
Do your worst.
Do my worst? Oh, you know I'm good. Oh. Woo! Dance, little sister! Come on! Kick his ass, dude!
What are you doing?
Dude, I'm whopping his ass. There we go! Beat down!
Maybe one of these Imperials had the key.
I know they do, dude. But we're gonna do, yeah, that thing is nice. We're gonna put on this and this and that. And let's go ahead and get rid of, how do I do it? Yeah, here. And then we get rid of, how do I store it? X. X is stored. I don't know any of that. Yeah! You know what? I do want this. I don't want the iron axe. I don't like the iron. I don't like axes. Weapons. We'll drop that in there. Store. Yes. Groucho, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. Back about an hour? All right. Well, there weren't gonna be no dragons this early on, dude. Except for the one that, just made a cameo. See, so you're gonna, dude. You wanted to. You just went and grabbed the key.
Here we are. Found the key.
Yeah, I know. I was looting the body, dude. You could have relaxed a little bit.
I'm on your side.
I know you. Get on my nerves, son.
Come on. Let's get out.
Storming the castle.
The
dude, I'm trying to run away from the castle.
Down on our heads.
Yay, cabbages! Can you pick things up in this game? No, you can't. Or you can, and I don't remember how. What have we got in here? Anything good? Oh, that's right. You can't. I have to actually search things, too. That's... Ooh, a carrot. I need carrots in Fallout. I don't need carrots here. Come on, man. Let's go whop some ass. With this teeny little Breton chick. That's I like to play the Bretons because they're so small. Oh, no! How dramatic. Come on, boys! Whatever, dude. It's the tutorial. I'm not gonna die. Beat down! You want it? I got some for you too, dude. Ooh! Yeah!
A storeroom. See if you can find any potions. We'll need them.
Hang on a second, dude. I gotta get these herbs. I wish I could grow these herbs. You can't grow these herbs, which is weird. Okay, let's put my bloody blade away. Man, the sensitivity is really high. Higher than I'm used to, I'm to be very, very careful. Hey, salt. Is that salt? Yes, it is. Yes, it is. You got any money on you, dude? No, nothing I want there. You can pick things up. I'm just doing it wrong. Okay, cool. What's in the cupboard? Ooh, gold, yeah. Clothes iron, yeah. Nope, not 10 to 1. We're not taking any of that crap. This, though. 17, 7. That one I'll take. Okay, and a barrel. Yay, barrels. Take all. Let's see. Items. And potions. And minor healing. I do favorite. Right? And I go up. And I hold this way. Right. So inside is potion of minor. Okay. Alright. We're getting here. Search sack. Of course, I'm sure if Groucho was still here, he would be taking great delight in me rifling through other people's sacks, because that would be that's like a no-brainer. Hey man, how you doing?
Done. Let's get moving.
Dude, I want that bow. Give me that bow. You can have the sword. Just give me the bow.
Troll's blood. It's a torture room.
Oh my god.
Come on.
Yeah. Final tap.
Bones. We're too late.
Shoulders.
Damn the Empire.
Bones. Now this guy's got the stuff right here. 10 to 1. Yes. No. No boots. Everything but. What have you got? Hide shield. Nah. Although I like to save those for gauntlets. I use those later when I craft. Yes. No. Yes. And the torture hood. Yes. No.
Looks like there's
Justin, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, man. How you doing this evening? Didn't know you played Skyrim? Oh, dude, Skyrim is my jam. Elder Scrolls.
Need that gold once we get out.
That was my one of my biggest disappointments of the
anything useful, and let's go.
Of the announcement of 76 is because we were due for Elder Scrolls 6. You know, it was in terms of the cycle, it's time because it's been 7 years. You know. Did he give me lockpicks? Oh, I got some out of the thing here. Now let's see how easy the lockpicking is in this thing here. Ah, blah, blah, I know. You're not there. See, I like this because this is where I got my quartering and my method of quartering it from the markings on these locks, because, you know, the two rivets are right there. Give me your stuff because you got the juice, dude. This is going to sell real nice to Lucan. Anything in there I want? Nah, we're good. We got all that stuff. Let's see what's back over here. Anything good over here? We got any money? I keep wanting to hit my Pip-Boy light, but I don't have the Pip-Boy light. So we're just gonna... Oh, lockpick. Yeah, I can use those. 1 and 2, 2 and 10. No. An iron shield in case I wanted to go heavy, which I do not. And off we go. Da-da-da-da. But, oh yes, I played Skyrim, dude. I have a sickening amount of hours in this game as well. So, Tamriel, how you doing, man? Can you move your butt out of my way? Companions never change. I could pick these locks for the XP, but I'd rather have the sneak. Now, normally what I do is when I get in here, right, he's got his two buddies, is I'll get in a dark corner and I'll just sneak against the wall for a while and just, you know, crank my sneak up because it's cheesy as hell. Because I still remember some of the, various... not exploits per se, but like glitches and workarounds and stuff like that. Like when we get to Riverwood, you know I'm going to be helping Fendall so I can loot his training fee out of his pockets because I'm a dick. Because I just don't care. Like I want my archer up to 50 so I can stop him in the tracks, man. Thong, you know? You get that stun. I love that stun, man. Yeah, we play light fighters like we always do, so my choices may be strange to you.
Orders are to wait until General Tullius arrives.
And I level up.
I'm not waiting to be killed by a dragon. We need to pull back.
Got it.
Man, she's a beast. Look at this. Heavy armor on my ass, dude. Do you have what I want? Yes. Yes, you do. Whoops! Didn't mean to do that. Okay, let's go back and not do that. Let's put that away. Equip this thing. Hell yes. Let's get rid of the other crap I don't need here. I want those. I don't need the boots. Bracers, yes. Novice hood, robes, torturer's hood, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right, you move so slow. Here we go. Raylof? Don't run in front of the gun, son. Okay.
Let's go on ahead. See if the way is clear.
Okay, do you have any more arrows? Yeah, I want arrows, dude. Give me those arrows. Yes, arrows. Love me those arrows. Give me that, this, and give me those. Okay, are there any more arrows here? I don't like the iron arrows because they're hard to see, because they're not, they don't have the little, they got the black fletching, not the red that the steel arrows do. That's why I prefer steel arrows, because I can retrieve the arrows a lot easier than trying to find them here on the road. You dropped a longbow, okay, that's fine. Oh, there's one. Okay. Chisel gang, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. Welcome to Escaping the Castle. Getting the hell out of Helgen. The kind you can't do the Fendel thing? Are you sure? Well, maybe if they cast it since I last played it. I'm still gonna try though, man. Still gonna try. Yeah, I know, dude. What have we got here? You've never seen Skyrim be played? Okay, well, you're gonna see it here, dude. Well, at least parts of it. We're at the very beginning where we're escaping the dragon attack on Helgen. But first, of course, we're going to have to go over here and search the skeleton. Gold, yes. A little pouch. Take the purse. Take the potion. Nothing else. Am I playing vanilla? Yes. Yes, I am, Dakai. I didn't do any mods. I just want to do a straight vanilla playthrough. I mean, I do have modded saves in here, and they're fun. It's its own kind of thing. I like the mods that let me not wear helmets, but get the bonuses from helmets and stuff. The kind of things I do in Fallout, the small changes, the quality of life stuff, but not the totally game breaking stuff. Because I mean, I already know how to do restoration potions. That still works. And as long as that still works, and I can't zoom yet, man. Oh, yeah, they got the spidey sense, too. Yep, come on. Follow them. There you go. There's one. And you. There's two. And you. Okay. That's going to be a come. Okay, cool. I will. Oh, gee. No. God, I missed my zoom. Oh, I just leveled. Awesome.
Too many eyes, you know?
Too many eyes. Yeah, I'm aware. They have just enough eyes, dude. They're spiders. Need your venom, because that stuff sells really good. You don't need more arrows? Yay, arrow. Give me the arrows. A silver ring? Wow. Cashed in on that one. Okay. Skeever tail? Yes. Twink. Sapper, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Yeah. Endlessly making new characters. Yeah, the character thing is pretty fun. But I get around that by just going to the face guy, the face person. The snotty, what is she, a dark elf? In Rift, and just, you know, fiddling with my features that way. Or, you know, blasting through and just doing other types of builds. This is one of the few games I've actually played a melee character and had a lot of fun with it. And my most challenging one was the one where my character never killed anything directly herself except dragons. And that was a hard one to start, but it was really fun near the end. So, yeah. Running around in a fine robe and nothing else, with no weapons or nothing, man. And just...
This way. Yeah.
So. Okay, come on, Raylof, let's go kill us a bear. It's the bear show! One thing I do like about the remastered version on the Xbox One is it's so smooth. It is so fast. I'm like, oh. I mean, yeah, it's an aging game. It's a 7-year-old game, so of course it's going to be quick, but I like it. I'm a big fan of performance over prettiness.
Hold up. There's a bear just ahead. See her?
Oh, roleplay part?
With her right now.
Yeah.
Let's try to sneak by. Just take it nice and slow. And watch where you step.
Give me another bow, dude. Or if I'm feeling like a beast, which I am, which I totally am, we drop this thing because I don't want that. Okay.
Keep. You can take this bow.
You know what, too? Let's do this while I'm in here. Let's just go ahead and drop the sword. I'm
take her by
it.
Surprise. Go ahead. I'll follow your lead and watch your back.
Yeah, you'll watch my back. Okay, this is definitely taking this. 12 to 1. Take all these. Hello. Anything else over here I can take? No? And that bear, gosh, she's the size of a house, man. Of course, without zoom. One thing I do like, too, about Skyrim is the arrow flight actually works. You know, as long as you can predict the arc and you can actually do side to side. You know, you can spin it off the bow and make it go sideways. Which I really have a good time with. Okay. So let's get the bear, because God knows I'm gonna need that leather. Hell yeah. Bear pelt. Four leather. Come on, Rayla. Let's get out here, son. Okay, so how did I do that? Ah, there it is. So I hold the button. Okay, there we go. There we go. La-dee-dee. But yeah, I went, I played a bunch of different archetypes. You know, the sword spell, the like sword the mage, and the conjurer, and, you know, like that. And then I played this one guy. I never did any quests at all. I just would log in and just hunt the plains of Whiterun. That was just fun. Am I using a companion? I have to, dude. But no, in this game I do not use companions, unless I have to. Survival? I do not want to play survival, no.
Wait!
Crouch, like it's gonna help you, dude. He's a dragon. He can probably smell you from up here.
There he goes. Looks like he's gone for good this time. No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. We better clear out of here.
My sister, Gerda, runs the mill in Riverwoods, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out. It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
It's best if we split up and I just stick with him. I'm like, yeah, I'm not going anywhere, dude. I am staying with you the entire way, my friend. I'm not letting you out of my sight.
You know, you should.
Yeah, I'm Justin, I am guilty of that myself, dude. If I see blue butterflies, I will stop. I will chase them down, dude. Let me get some thistle, some blue, some purple. Okay, come on, dude. Mountain flowers ain't worth much of a piss. All they give you is healing potions, but it's experience and it's money, so. God, it's so smooth. I cannot get over how smooth it is. One thing I never really did get good at, though, is the third-person archery. I've seen people on streams that are just godlike with the bow in third-person. And I can hit stuff What? Help? From what, dude? And I do like the fact that the road signs actually mean something. So many little details about this game that I enjoy and appreciate very, very much.
See that ruin up there? Bleak Falls Barrow. I never understood how my sister could stand living in the shadow of that place. I guess you get used to it.
Dude, there's shadows everywhere. You're living in mountains. The sun probably sets at 2 o'clock in the afternoon here. Okay. Well, we'll get the flowers later. I'll just grab the stuff I can while we're cruising with Rayloff here. Da, da, da. Guardian stones.
These are the guardian stones.
Hey, I'm a person. How you doing? Welcome to the stream.
Standing stones that dot Skyrim's landscape.
Okay, so which one do you guys think I'm going to pick? Am I going to pick Thief Mage, or am I going to pick the Warrior Stone? I'm pretty sure I'm going to pick Thief.
Thief, eh?
Thief, eh?
It's never too late to take charge of your own fate, you know.
Oh, son, I take charge of everything. You just watch. You have no idea who you're talking to, son. And at this point in the game, if you haven't played it, neither do you. Nobody knows who he's talking to. Just you're the prisoner. Yay, thistle. Give me that. Thistle does what? Cold, right?
Remember, this isn't Stormcloak territory. If we're ahead of the news from Helgen, we should be fine. As long as we don't do anything stupid. If we run into any Imperials, just let me do the talking, alright?
Sure, dude. I'm dressed in Imperial gear, but you do the talking. You're a Stormcloak rebel, and I'm dressed like an Imperial. But you go ahead and do the talking. That makes perfect sense. Mora Tapanella, hello. Okay. Where are they? Ooh, flowers! Yay! Give me that. I like when it says red, but they're actually kind of orange. Where'd you go, dude? Oh, there you are. It's hardy hardy, my friend. Oh. He's like, we gotta split up, then he stops and waits for me. I heard you. Where you at, you little shit? Come on. There you are. I see ya. You see him? I do. Come. Bad puppy. Brighten up, pooper. Give me that. Need the pelts. Need the pelts. Gotta make leather. Got to make the leather. Okay.
I'm glad you decided to come with me. We're almost to Riverwood.
Do I have a general idea we want this character in the Blade game? Nah, I just, like I said, I play him and see what happens, you know? If anyone, I don't want to, if I have too much of a plan, then I can get all, well, this is not what I wanted to do, but if I just kind of wing it and just kind of do whatever, I'm always doing what I want, and then I just kind of see what happens. Because exploring and just, you know, saying, oh, look at that map marker, I'm just going to go see what the hell that is. And then one thing leads to another, and it's 3 hours later, and I've got to get up and work in 4 hours, and I'm like, what happened? How'd that happen? That's the type of game I like, when you can just sort of lose yourself in it. Not like, oh my god, you know, the world just falls away, but more like, I'm so riveted by what I'm doing and the stuff that's happening, I just want to keep going. You know, I want to see what happens, because I don't know what's going to happen. I mean, sometimes I'll just go around picking flowers, sometimes I'll go try and hunt elk to skin them for the leather and sell it, sometimes I'll just try and work my way to a different town, sometimes I'll just follow a road and see where it goes, you know? Because that's what I like about these types of games. They're sandboxy, but they're also sort of... They're sandboxy, but they have a narrative if you want to follow it. They give you options. Oh, Sven, you slacker.
I saw a dragon!
What? What is it now, Mother?
It was as big as the mountain and black as night. It flew right over the barrel.
Dragons now, is it? Please, Mother. If you keep on like this, everyone in town will think you're crazy. And I've got better things to do than listen to more of your fantasies.
Or just, you know, hitting
Did
the skooma.
Talking to Sven?
Ooh,
maybe not.
Ben.
Maybe Riverwood's agreeable enough, I suppose.
For a Nord village. For a Nord village. Divine smile on you, friend.
He's a bard, so he says. Occasionally, he finds time to do his job here at the mill. Thinks his ballads and sonnets are going to convince an intelligent, beautiful woman. I've been thinking. Could you give her this letter and say it's from Sven?
Sure.
I think I've matched that Nord's lack of cleverness perfectly. Tell me, as soon as you've given command...
He's such a dick. But you know what? You got to admire his industry. He's like, you know what? I can't win her over, so I'm just going to jack with the other dude.
Do you really know Altered Stormcloak?
Hush, Frodnar. This is no time for your games. Go and watch the South Road.
I'm going to go ahead and pick all the plants, guys. You don't mind me, okay?
Look at you, almost a grown man. Won't be long before you'll be.
The dog is very large.
Himself.
You don't really
That's
notice
right.
how big he is.
Don't
I mean,
worry,
look at this. He's
Rayloff.
As big as she is. It's like a very large dog.
Now, Rayloff, what's going on?
You two look pretty well. Let's go see. Where is the? Yeah, the axe is over here, right? Yeah. Anything in the barrels? No. And oh, yeah, tomatoes are good. Give me those. Need those tomatoes. It's tomato season. Now I'm gonna need to find some basil. Hey, you guys got any mozzarella cheese in here? No? Probably not. Okay. Off we go.
2 days ago.
Gotta remember where that axe is.
We stopped in Helgen this morning, and I thought it was all over. Had us lined up to the headsman's block and ready to start chopping.
The cowards.
They wouldn't dare give Ulfric a fair trial. Treason for fighting for your own people.
All of Skyrim would have seen the truth then. But then, out of nowhere, a dragon attacked.
You don't mean a real, live...
I can hardly believe it myself. And I was there. As strange as it sounds, we'd be dead if not for that dragon. In the confusion, we managed to slip away. Are we really the first to make it to Riverwood?
Nobody else has come up the South Road today, as far as I know.
Good.
Russell, how you doing? Welcome to the stream.
I hate
I didn't see you come in, man. How you doing?
Nonsense.
Been a while. No, I've only been going, well, since about 7. It's about a half an hour
at
this point.
Let me worry about the Imperials. Any friend of Raylov's is a friend of mine.
You know, I do like how they immediately trust her.
You like. If there is anything
when she's wearing
need,
Imperial armor. I don't know why that cracks me up. Yeah, I'm going to take everything. I'm just going to take it all. Just give me everything. Thank you.
There is
Thank you
something
for your generosity.
You could do for me. For all of us here.
Yeah?
The Jarl needs to know if there's a dragon on the loose. Riverwood is defenseless. We need to get word to Jarl Balgruuf in Whiterun to send whatever troops he can. If you'll do that for me, I'll be in your debt.
Yeah, Thanks, sure. Sister. I guess if I'm heading that way...
I knew we could count on you.
To get back to work.
Quests are here. Okay, get rid of that.
But I missed, but did anyone else escape?
So they're gonna yap. I don't need to hear their crap. Let's go, talk to Shelby. I mean, Elisif. I mean, Isolde. I mean, Muri. I mean, Camilla. That's who I'm gonna talk to. Been better? Dude!
But one of us has to do something.
Are you okay? What is it with my viewers falling off stuff, man? You've tumbled down the stairs and fire gun fell off a roof?
Then,
hey, anybody listening, don't fall down
we
things, okay?
We are done talking about this. Oh, a customer. Sorry you had to hear that.
God, she looks constipated, doesn't she? Hey, girl.
Maybe
up?
You could talk some sense into my pig-headed brother. You're not from around here. That makes two of us. Another poem, I bet. He does know how to make a girl blush. What's this? If that oaf thinks all I'm going to do is stay in that filthy house of his and clean, I'll... You can tell Sven that he already has a mother. I'm not speaking to him anymore.
Damn, Russell. Well, I hope you get better, man.
I don't know what you overheard, but the Riverwood Trader is still open. Feel free to shop.
You know what? I'm going to talk to Alvor first, I think. Because I think he'll be over here, right? Yeah, there you are. Let's talk to you first.
Papa's isn't too friendly.
What's up, big guy?
Ain't every day we get visitors at Riverwood.
Taint every day. What about my taint, dude? What are you talking about?
Yes, actually. How about you smith me an iron dagger? Here's everything you need to make one. Go ahead.
Alright. Someone else is using this. Yeah, smith you an iron dagger. No problem, dude.
That's a decent weapon you've made there.
I like how when he gives you a task to do, right? He's like, can you need any help around the forge? He's like, sure, do an iron dagger. I'm going to go hold the building up
My
while you work for me.
The
Whatever you need. Not bad, but it's a little dull. How about you sharpen it up? Just need a bit of metal and the grindstone over there. You
Someday,
looking for a new
I'm going
blade?
To forge my own sword.
Aye.
So did he just give me the stuff I needed? Let's find out. Yeah, he did. And craft.
Papa says I'm not ready for weapons.
This looks good. You want to keep helping? How about you make some armor? Let's start by tanning some leather on the rack.
This isn't a nice little intro, I gotta say, though. This is a great introduction to all the various things you need to do to craft... Okay, craft all my leather there. Dun-dun-dun. How you doing, buddy?
Mama doesn't think I'm
could...
girlish.
Ah, good.
That's a stupid girl.
Let's see if you can make a hide helmet. Here's the rest of what you need. Hide.
Hide helmet. You go, buddy.
I should hire you to be my assistant at this rate. Let's improve the fit. Take this leather to the workbench over there.
So, personal space. Okay, and hide helmet, fine, I'm good. How you doing, buddy?
You have talent. Keep working at your craft, and you'll be a fine smith one day. Why don't you keep that dagger and helmet? Maybe you'll remember me when you're making Skyforge steel, huh?
I'm making some better shit than that, dude. Okay, now is he still open? Hopefully he's still open. Yes. Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Now it's time to sell every damn...
The Riverwood Trader is everything you need. My sister Camilla or I will be happy... We did have a bit of a break-in. But we still have plenty to sell. Robbers were only after one thing. An ornament. Solid gold in the shape of a dragon's claw.
So... The guy, he's confused why a thief would steal something that's, what, about 2 pounds of solid gold? Gosh, I can't imagine what the value could be there, Lucan.
I've got some coin coming in from my last shipment. It's yours if you bring my claw back. Now, if you're going to get those thieves, you should head to Bleak.
Yeah, whatever.
Some may call this junk. I call them treasures.
Okay. Let's see what we've got. Sell the iron dagger. And sell the hide helmet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sell 6 of those. These. Iron helmet hood. This, that. Yeah, I'm not getting much for this, but who cares? I just need to sell it. Because I don't need any of it. I don't use those. Don't use these. I could probably sell maybe 5 of those, 6 of those. Yeah, we'll do that. Sell all the wine, sell the bread. Yeah, I'll just sell everything. Doesn't matter. Okay, the ingredients I got to keep. Let's learn that. But the dragonborn, I'll sell that. Miscellaneous, I need all those things. Okay, so how much money do I have? 750, huh? That's not bad.
So this is your plan, Lucan?
Da-da-da-da-da. Now, let's see. Let's pick some... There's some thistle over here, right? Yeah. That stuff makes pretty good frost potions. Don't need flour. Can always use tomatoes. Yeah, she's just talking. Blah, blah, blah. That's one thing they did do with the special edition that I'm not really a fan of, is whenever you're close to something, it blurs out everything in the background. Hang on a second. I gotta fix something here on my other laptop. I always forget to turn flux off. Screen turns orange and I can't read anything, so let me just disable this bad boy until sunrise. Perfection. Okay. Alright, got that set up. But yeah, it blurs things. It does this, like, focus blur, and I'm just like, it's disorienting, you know, a little disorienting. But yeah.
Those,
you know what?
Must be mad hiding out there. Those old crypts are filled with nothing.
Those old crypts are filled with nothing, but excuse me, I have to go in here. Here we go. Delphine.
Orgnar. Are you listening?
Hard not to.
The ale is going bad. We need to get a new batch. Did you hear me?
Yep, ale's going bad.
I guess you don't have potatoes in your ears after all. Just make sure we get a fresh batch in soon.
You know that visitor's been poking around.
We got... Need a room? Talk to Delphine. Long as you clean up, you know how to use it, right? Mix a couple of ingredients together, see what happens. A little wheat and blister wart makes a healing potion, if you didn't know. We have plenty of ingredients for sale, too. There have been whispers. A boy up in Windhelm, name of Aventus Aretino, been trying to contact the Dark Brotherhood. Have you seen that Shrine of Azura? They say the Dark Elves built it after they fled from Morrowind. Sight to see. Until next time. I'm just a cook, lass. Word is, Ulfric's Stormcloak escaped from the Imperials. War's only gonna get worse now. We've got something of a love triangle here in Riverwood. Faendal and Sven. Here, take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Just don't let it be halted. Stream, Silent Moons. Okay, Silent Moons is
probably...
What the hell did you just do, dude? Okay, so now what we're going to do is I'm going to just go ahead and not even bother mixing and matching. I'm just going to eat a bunch of stuff. Eat, eat, eat. Need to learn these things here. She's going to... damage stamina. But yeah, that's how I basically discover all the new stuff I've got because... Alright. So damage stamina, wow, really? That sells for 30? Hell yeah, we'll make that. Restore magicka. See, resist frost is thistle.
Coming right
and
up.
And something else. I don't know. I don't have anything else. Butterfly wing and 17? Yeah, sure, what the hell. And no, I'll save those for later. Now of course we do the experimentation. Will this work? Whoa! Lucked out on that one. Damn, son! That was a good chunk right there. Okay. Okay, we know what that does.
This is an ode to Skyrim's staunch protectors.
Nothing there. I know those two won't work together. Nothing there. Just use these all up and just experiment. Wow. That's a good one. Holy crap, I'm making two of those. And anything? No? Okay. Nothing there. So purple and thistle? There it is. That's the one I wanted right there. Okay, so now we skilled up our alchemy a little bit. Got some stuff to sell to old Lucan. Hopefully he's still open. Oh, wrong door. Duh. Been drinking too much mead. I forgot which door I was going out. Oh crap, it's dark. He's probably closed. Please don't be closed. Good. Excellent. Now we're going to see if he's got any magic items or any weapons worth a piss.
Mara, bless you for agreeing to help us.
Show them! Take a look.
Show them! Take a look. Okay, dude, what have you got for apparel? Minor magicka? No. Necklace of Minor Sure Grip. Ring of Minor Sneaking. 2,700? Yeah, that's a little bit outside my, that's a little outside my price range there, Lucan. Of course, if you only got 500 gold, dude, how are you selling stuff for 2,700? Where are you getting the money for that? Ah, loose economy. And yeah, nothing in here. I could buy iron arrows, but he doesn't even sell iron arrows. Oh, he does. There's three of them. Whatever. He's only got 145, huh? Anything in miscellaneous that I can... Ooh, yeah. You know what? I can do that. Let's do that. Do you sell just straight-up leather? No, you do not. Huh. Books. Clairvoyance, Frostbite, Fury, Wards. I don't need any of that stuff. So let's go ahead and see what we got here. Yeah, look at that, man. I'm just going to be rolling in cash here. Let's sell the high ticket item first, then. Yeah, look at that! Speech increased to 21? Yeah, he didn't really have much of anything. I can't just put it in the hopper and then just fill it up. Minor Sure Grip, I don't need that. I would like that, but I can't afford it. I am poor. I am poor and have no money. What do I got for books? Oh, I gotta learn that, spell. Okay, let's learn the spell. Probably already know it. Nope, I don't. Excellent.
Then. You're okay. Not from around here. That makes sense.
The sooner you find... Some may call this junk. I call them treasures.
Miscellaneous. Bear pelt. Give me two of those. And let's see if I've got enough potions to cover that. Ah, I do. Okay. And then I got 18 worth there. How much is he asking for a deer hide? 30? Yeah, that'll work. That'll be fine. What do I got for food in here? Oh, four more tomatoes. Okay, so I got 886. Doing pretty good. All right. Doing pretty good. Now we go, upgrade her, her gear here a little bit, because I know from experience that leather armor is just better than the Imperial armor. Oh, no, can't do that yet. Now we're going to see if I've got enough leather to actually even do this. I don't know if I do or not. Let's hope I do. Two for that one, eight for that one. I got 18 leather, huh? And I'm going to need at least eight of those. Let's see if I can do this. Leather. Leather armor. Okay. Leather boots. Leather bracers. Leather helmet. Look at that! And I still have seven leather left. Yay! Still have seven leather. So now let's go ahead and improve everything. Why don't you improve the fit? So it goes from what? 28 to 30? That's good. I'll take it. 8 to 9. 8 to 9. And 13 to 14. Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Miscellaneous and apparel. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, so we're done with him. What's my burden at? Carry weight 39 out of 300? Yeah, no problem. Alright, you know what? Let's level up. Yeah, we have to level up. Always stamina. Oh, I'm almost level 3 too. Okay, Fendal, where are you, dude? No, it's here. Talk to Fendal. Show on map. Oh, he's in his house. Damn it, I'm not gonna be able to talk to him, alright. I wish I could just knock on his door, but you have to actually break into his friggin' house, and it's like, that doesn't make any sense to me. Can I just knock? Oh, look at that, I can just open it up. Perfect. Alright, now let's see if the trick works with him. Hey, Fendal, how you doing, man?
Tell me, as soon as you've given Riverwood's agreeable enough, I appreciate your help. Please, take this. Some gold I've saved up from working at the mill.
25. Follow me, I need your help.
Lead the way.
Yeah. Okay, let's see if this even works. Let's see if this even works.
I'm right behind you.
I'll show you what I know.
I'll show you what I know.
Okay, I've got 900 gold. Okay, so we did that, right? Now, I need to trade some things with you.
What do you want me to carry?
Do you have my money? You do. So I take the money back.
I'll show you what I know.
So we're going to sit here. So if you want to refill your drink, feel free to do so right now, because we're going to be here for a couple of minutes.
What do you want me to carry?
As I buy his training, level up. I'm going to get stamina.
Lead on.
And now that I've leveled, I can buy five more points. And at the earlier levels, it goes up very, very quick. Okay, and I need to trade some things.
What do
you
want me to carry? I'll show you what I know.
So we're going to cycle this till I hit 50, basically. Okay.
What do you want me to carry?
But the trick is I have to level right away, and this is a somewhat...
You lead, I'll follow.
Risky proposition for people who are at the earlier levels who have never played the game, because the enemies scale, so I'm... basically in level 1 armor at level 7. But
I'll show you what I know.
I just love it. I love doing this. Train. Train. Don't have enough.
What do you want me to carry?
What do you want me to carry? I want you to give my money back so I can train more.
I'll show you what I know.
Some friends you are not even offering me a discount, man. That's pretty cold.
What do you want me to carry?
Learn something new every 20 minutes. Well, that's the thing. If you played archers like I do, I mean, I never saw this on like a board. I actually discovered this myself by accident because I needed somebody to go with me to Bleak Falls Barrow, and I'm like, I'm not going by myself, man. But the unofficial patch, I think, fixes this. There are some mods that do fix this.
I'll show you what I know.
But I just love doing this. So 5 out of 5, and up.
What do you want me to carry?
So I think I'm gonna peek here. I think I'm gonna be done. And then out, and then level. Stamina again.
Let's get going then.
No, we're good.
I'll show you what I know.
Yeah, you're damn right you will. 1 and 2.
What do you want me to carry?
This only works with him though. This little thing where you get the money back.
I'll show you what
I
know.
No other trainer has this problem. I just gotta remember.
What do you want
to
me to carry?
Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to level, I don't think. Can you train
I'll
me?
I'll show you what I know.
And train. Is that enough? Oh, it's not enough.
What do you want me to carry?
That's okay. Alright, so we got that. Now we go to skills. Go straight to friggin' archery. And of course, if you've never played the game before, red is warrior skills, blue is mage skills, and green is thief skills. So I basically live and die in this I live and die in this tree right here at the start. I don't need critical shot. This I need. But I need 50 for that bad boy. And I got 2 perks, so I'm gonna keep those for now, I think, although I'm tempted to get sneak, but we will see here. Yeah, because what I really want is this one here. No, ranger, move faster with the drawn bow. That's my money right there. That one and the power shot. The stagger. I love the stagger. The stagger saves my life more than anything else. Yeah. I'll do that.
Let's get going then.
Now, I just have a longbow, right? Potion of True Shot. Wait a minute, how can I take this? See, we're friends and stuff, but that's over 50. I shouldn't be able to take that. Well. Ooh. Take those, though. Let's go make some leather, baby. What have you got? Anything else that's worth a pass? Anything I want to get? Gold, yes. Parker Tusk. Yeah, 15 to 1, but nobody's open. Hunting bow. Yeah, that's right, because the longbow. The longbow takes firewood 10 and 5. This is 12 and 7. But heavier means it's a slower draw. Do I want that right now? Yeah, I do. I do, absolutely do. Let's get rid of the longbow. Let's go ahead and make the hunting bow and get rid of that. No. That, store that. Get that out of my thing. And you know what? We're just gonna get rid of these. We're gonna dump them in here for now. I'm not gonna use them. 35 out of 320. Huh? Good. Do I want you to come with me? Yeah.
Still here.
Oh no, he is following me. Okay.
You come lead, on, I'll follow.
Let's rock and roll. Let's go clear out a mine. Let's get you some equipment. We need to get you some gear. We need to wait for the sun to come up. So, while we're doing that, on the way here, I passed a side street that I noticed that had an icon. And since I am invariably curious about what things are, we're gonna go to the mine. And now she's looking a little bit more adventury, a little more tribal. Looking good. See, let's go to the mine here. No, not yet. I got leather strips. Let's not forget to upgrade that damn bow. This is what I forget early on, especially at first. I always forget that I need to check for upgrades every time I come back to town. Of course, with smithing, the thief stone going, I'm not going to get as much. Yeah, 13, what the hell, I'll take it. I got the leather strips, might as well use them. Yeah, see that thing, man? It's a slow draw. But yeah, we're level 5. That definitely changed, though. I was usually able to just vault all the way up to 7 just by buying that, but something must have happened. I do have the thief stone going, though, don't I? Thought I did. Yeah. All stealth skills increase 20% faster. Okay. Well, thanks, Russell. I'm glad they have some entertainment value and some other type of value. I'm not going to deal with clams right now, or oysters, or trout, or whatever. I don't want to deal with that shit. We need to keep an eye out for is Abyssinian longfin and Cyrodiilic spadetail. Because I am not adverse to using the fortify restoration thing. I use it sparingly. I don't get like 9 million points of damage bows, but I do. I like them to get in the 500 range just because it's funny. And of course, you know, enchanting the armor, so I have like 127% to bow on every piece of armor or whatever. Okay. So, Nacho, how you doing, man? Any special challenge rules? Nah, man, I'm just farting around. I'm just, this is, I guess, the best way to describe this, Nacho, would be this is the palate cleansing run. I need to play something that's Bethesda that's not Fallout, you know? To try and,
Think we should check it out?
Think we should check it out? I don't know. I'm totally gonna. Hey, Mr. Bandit, you wanna be a dick, dude? Look.
Time to end this.
Yeah. Maybe get the well rested. Yeah, I didn't even think about that, Suicide Toast. Thanks for the tip. And welcome to the stream, man. How you doing? Ooh, he had a gemstone. Ooh, yeah. Well, we're not gonna deal with that right now, I don't think. But what we are gonna do really quick. Take the thistle. And we go, hey Fendel. How you doing, man? What's up, buddy? Okay. Well, I didn't expect him to come up. I didn't know there were three back there. Alright, dude, put the dagger away. Okay. Now, level up. And stamina. 37 archery, huh? We need to get to 50, buddy.
I got your back.
Can you train me to be better archery?
I'll show you what I know.
Roach, how you doing? Am I going to do a stealth bow build? Oh, you bet your ass I am. That is what I do, my friend. I love these builds. I need to train
what do you want me to carry?
Of course, she's not very sneaky and, she's not very good with the bow quite yet.
I'll show you what I know.
But, train. Train.
What do you want me to carry?
Train of fools. And hopefully I can, if JPEG stops in, I can show him how to use the bows.
I'll show you what I know.
Because he didn't like to play Skyrim because of the way the bows work, I guess. But, I've been dying to show him. I was like, hey, dude, you can use bows.
What do you want me to carry?
It's totally cool. You just got to get used to how they drop and the physics of them. Why always stamina? Let me go ahead and finish this up really quick. I do it for the first 5 levels, right? Like right now, I'll start alternating stamina and health. But in Skyrim, have you played Skyrim, Nacho? I'm assuming that you have. Stamina gives me 2 things as a sneaky archer. One, it gives me carry weight, which, you know, of course, I love carry weight. And number 2, when I zoom, I burn stamina. So if I'm a sniper, I want to zoom as long as possible. And the more stamina I have in the bank, the faster I can, the more I can sprint, the longer I can zoom, and the better I can just do the things I need to do. Because if I'm doing my job right as a sneaky sniper, I shouldn't be getting hit at all. So let's go ahead and crank that one out.
Lead on.
And are we
still
are
here?
We capped? We capped, right?
I'll show you what I know.
Stamina at first, then I alternate with health. And then, okay, 5 out of 5. Okay.
Let's get going then.
All right, man. Now let's see. How much did my bow improve here? It was 13. Now it's 15. Yeah, that's fine. 20. It does 23. Okay, I'll do that. But yeah, at the first, it's always stamina. You know, because like I said, when I zoom in, can I zoom yet? See, I'm burning stamina, right? So if I have a lot of stamina, man.
Oh.
If I have a lot of stamina, I can zoom for a long time. Do I also have the DLCs? This is the special edition, so I guess so, yes. I'm not looking forward to the vampires killing all my NPCs.
Don't
not
like
a fan
the
of
looks of this.
Yeah, I know you don't, dude, but let's just take the torches. We're gonna be in the dark, buddy. Okay. We're gonna be in the dark. I hope this is not too dark for y'all as we go through here, but I am very, very happy to do this. I love doing this. Because it makes me feel like a total badass. And I love the fact that the bandits... See, I want to call them raiders, right? I love the fact that the bandits don't seem to notice all the lights are going out. All the torches are burning out at once. They're like... Okay, how you doing, buddy? Go for the drop, aim a little low at the neck, and pop! Someone there. Is someone there? No, your friend just had a heart attack. He had an aneurysm, dude. Done by a bow. So he's gonna come up the stairs. Come on, dude. You like that? That's right. So that's why I have stamina. That way it's a lot easier for me to lead targets, a lot easier for me to track them. I can keep an eye on them a lot simpler. Gold lockpick. I'm gonna give him my bow back, huh? Let me have that. Let me take that. Hide armor's crap. Okay, here, dude.
Still here.
What do you want me to carry?
What do you want me to carry?
What I want you to carry, my friend, is this weapon. I want to take you the Steel War Axe. Give us X.
Lead on. Okay.
Am I gonna do mods? Not in this. Not yet. I mean, like I said, this is just a palate cleansing. I just want to play this and just have fun and not worry about. Studded armor. Hello. Give me that. What's up, dude? Time for you to get an upgrade.
I'm right behind you.
What do you want me to carry?
What do you want me to carry?
What I want you to carry is this, my friend. Gear up, stud.
Lead on.
You damn right I'm leading on. Okay, let's get this, let's grab this. And I'm gonna do something that, you may get annoyed with. I hope you do not, but, I hate waiting around for the animations. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There we go. Done. Okay. Weapons. Let's make this a favorite. Make this a favorite. Yeah. Yeah, let's do that. Much better. Okay. I took a meme in the thumbs. Okay, Nacho, you're fired. You're fired, dude. You were fired. Okay, now let's move you out of the way. Come here, dude. We don't want any questions going. Yeah, you do fit to the railing. Get over there. Whoop, out you go. Give me that. And then we'll take this one here as well. I need to drop these off at some point. Uh-oh, Roach. Jeez, that's sorry to hear that, man. That's not it's not cool, man. That's not cool. Now, see, normally I save these little journals, so when I get a house, I make an entire library of nothing but journals, because I like the way the little books look. For now, however, we're just going to leave them alone. I'm not saving stuff like that anymore. And you can't put all these lights out, which is unfortunate. Alto? Yes, I will take Alto. What have we got? Carrots? I don't need carrots. Okay, rock stars. You ready to rock and roll? Party time! Yeah, see, I don't have the forward flip yet either, so we're gonna have to do this in the dark. Come on, bitch, go to the doorway. You know you want to. Legendary difficulty? Oh, no, no, no. This is like average or novice or whatever. I'll check in a minute. I don't like you. Huh? No. No. Oh, Jesus, what? Yeah, no. Everybody just simmer down. Hit! Ugh, yeah, you should have just swung faster, dude. So, yeah, I don't really, I mean, I might do it later on, but for the time being, I just want to fart around and just play and not worry about crap like that. Two-handed guys are not my favorites, though. Oh, and this game has auto-heal, doesn't it? I forgot about that, too. Okay. Let's go ahead and get rid of these, actually, I'll leave it on the bodies here. I hope you guys can see this, man. It's really dark, but then again, my laptop is super bright, so maybe that's screwing me up. Oh no. Okay. Oh, don't get the axe, dude. Come on. Okay. You know, I have to admire the bandits, though. At least they're industrious, right? They're actually mining stuff, and they're working to make stuff. So I can appreciate that a little bit. Now, one of the cool things about Skyrim that I really like, one of the things about the enemy AI that I really do appreciate, is what you're going to see here next. Enemies respond to sound, right? And they're inquisitive about where sounds come from. So there's a guard around this corner right here. I think if I'm not being cheesy, I can see them when I peek through here. Yeah, you see them in the chair right there? You can see their armor there? So I know there's a guard there behind the thing. I could try and snipe to the door, but the doors don't always work what I want. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot an arrow into that stump right there. When she hears it, she's like, what's that sound? Doink! So that's a little trick you can use. Just shoot arrows near them, and they will go check out the source of the sound, and you can just plug them in the bag. And if you pay attention to where your arrow went, you can retrieve it, so I don't even lose it. Haha! Okay. So there's that. You can see as well, of course. Dim but still watchable? Alright, perfect. Cool, man. Because, of course, I like being sneaky, and I don't like to have a lot of light around. How are we out here? Oh, yeah, man. These locks are so much... Oh, wrong way. I was just about to say, these locks are so much softer than Fallout 4. And it feels more precise because your pick is a sharp instrument. You know, it's not a bobby pin. It's not square. It's pointed. So it's like you feel like you're more accurate. What we got in here? I'll take that. Take this. Sell that. Sure, why not? Sure, it's 8 pounds, but it's 900, so it's worth taking. Clairvoyance. Money, 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 money. Get the money. Ooh, white cap. That's right, this place has... These people do have ingredients sometimes in these bags. I will say I did get spoiled on Fallout 4's. Hover over it and it opens up. I don't wear out my A button trying to do it. You know what? We're going to just...
I've got your back. What do you want me to carry?
What do I want you to carry, dude? Do I want to give you a new weapon? Do I want to give you this thing? Or this... You know what? I'm going to give you this thing. Take that. And I'm going to take that axe from you so you use it. Because you'll still use this since it has better base damage because you're dumb. Give me that too so you won't accidentally pull that out.
Let's get going then.
Yeah, let's do that. Let's put these things in the trunk so they'll recycle. Magic can see in the dark without making light. Yes, I vaguely recall. I know the Nightingales have that ability. I'm pretty sure you can see in the dark there. But no, detect life is what I do. I am a huge fan of detect life. I am a terrible. That's my aura whisper is my shout. That is all I ever use. Aura whisper. Because that's like God mode, man. When you're a sneaky sniper, dude, it's like aura whisper is my jam. That reminds me, I gotta go find it. Gotta go get that quick. Of course, I have to unlock shouts first. And that's not something I'm looking forward to, but... okay. So now, let's go ahead and put out the lights here. Boom, boom, out go the lights way up high. Way up high, up, okay. Let's get Mr. Archer. You see the archer? Can you see him walking back there? I do. Come on, you little shit. You're gonna come down right about there. Can I hit him? Bet you I can. Doink! Bam! Like a boss. That's why I have stamina, Nacho. Right there. So I can keep the zoom on for a long time, lead my targets, predict where they're gonna be, and put an arrow and watch them walk right into it. So delightful.
I was sure I heard something.
Yeah, you sure as hell did. You know what you heard? You heard an arrow whisper through the air like this. Right in the spleen. Oh my goodness gracious. And the other ones didn't even wake up. That's how stealthy that shot was, dude. There's an orc over here by the blacksmith.
Wow.
Oh yeah, dude.
Would you look at that?
Yeah, it's a waterfall and a forge, dude. You've never seen a waterfall before? There you are. Hold still, dude. Now watch. Come on. Boom! The one thing about shooting too in this game, if you flick the stick left and right as you release, the arrow will actually arc left and right in flight. So you can sort of spin the arrow into the target, which I do a lot just out of habit now. That's what you just saw there, where I was aiming to the left sort of, but the arrow went right on target. Because they sort of flick the stick when I let go of the string. Bam! And the arrow will get a little English on it. So yeah, I can go side to side, up and down. The only thing I cannot do very well is drop it on them from a long distance. Like if I'm more than, say, I don't know, 150, 200. Dude, will you get out of my face, please? Personal space, Spendal. Good God, get out of the way. But yeah. Sword and shield. I've done melee as well. You know, the crash and smash, you know, sword and board. That's like, yeah, that's fun. I prefer the slower pace, I guess, of this. And, I don't know, I just like sneaky builds, man. I just like doing sneaky shit. Give me those ingots. Now, this place does not have transmute, right? It's halted stream mine. You know what?
I'm right behind you. All right, what is it? What do you need? Okay, got it.
Will he pick it up? Okay, so that's something I have to remember.
Anything else?
Because when you pick up a book, you learn the skill immediately, right? But if I have a follower, I can make the follower pick up the book, and then whenever I want to learn the skill, I just go back to him and go, hey, dude, give me that crap out of your inventory, and boom, 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 boom. So I don't accidentally level up too quickly, which means, by the way, let's choose health this time. And we need 60 there. And see, I don't really like the slow time one. The slow time throws my rhythm off. That I might get, but you know what? Let's just go ahead and get sneak too. We're gonna get sneak. Yeah, that'll work. Now, fend off. Evodio, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Can you train me to be better at archery?
I'll show you what I know.
You damn right you will. One, two.
What do you want me to carry?
Come on.
I'll show you what I know. What do you want me to carry?
We're getting there. 46. We're almost there.
I'll show you what I know.
All right, Roach. Thanks for stopping by, man. It's all good, man. The stream will be up later on tonight, tomorrow. You can watch the rest of it then, if you want to.
What do you want me to carry?
Oh, and I leveled. Yay! Okay, we're done. Yeah. Level up. So now we alternate. Stamina. And then we go to here.
I'll follow.
By no price.
Still here.
All right, man. Take it easy, Roach. See you in the next one, man.
I'll show you what I know.
I'll be in a cave learning how to be better at archery. And two. Any trades
what do you want me to carry?
Just one more point, baby. That's all I need is one more point.
I'll show you what I know.
Bam!
All right, what is it?
No, I don't need that, actually. Nothing.
I'm right behind you. What do you
want
me to carry?
And see, now that I'm at 50, he caps at 50, so I can't buy skill points from him anymore. But that's fine. That's fine.
Lead on.
All right, so here we go. And what I was doing the whole time. Ba-bam! That is what I wanted. I need 60 for that one, so now I can skip archery until I hit 60. I need 60 for the next rank of bow damage. Oh, but I do want that too. Do I want to buy more sneak, or do I want to actually do the critical hang so I can work my way up to Hunter's Discipline? Well, I'm going to level pretty quick, and I'm doing pretty good on sneak, so let's just do that. All right. Now go loot these poor bastards, see what we else have got in here. Actually, you know what? Yeah, that orc is over here. You're here, right? Yeah. I don't need anything off of you. I got 1,000 gold. I'm doing pretty good, right? Doing pretty good. The orc's over here. Gold lockpick. For armor, for bracers, for shoes. Yeah. Fendall will be fine. And here's the archer. Nord needs crap. But iron arrows? Yes, please. Thank you. Need more arrows. I need more arrows. And, there's something. Isn't it over here? No? You know what? Let's go ahead and do this so we can see. I can't see anything in here. And left hand. Okay. Oh no, the chimes. Oh, that's right. There's an ore vein here. Okay, so pickaxe, yes. Excellent. Two, three, four, six, seven, eight, nine. Okay. All done. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, no, 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 no. Okay. That's not what I wanted to do. Let's just hit these. Why not? I need to go back the other way through the tunnel. I will leave this for now because I have to go. Where is it? Here? Yeah, let's go through here. And 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then there's a chest. So you have to love this. I have a torch in my left hand, a pickaxe in my right, but I'm picking a lock. That's how talented she is. Pushing minor stamina, whatever, that's fine. Come on, buddy. We're getting out of this cave. I just wanted to get some experience and get my bow so we can go explore Bleak Falls Barrow, where we will be doing some murdering, because that is the economy of... Ooh, charred skeever hide. Give me that. Cure disease right there, baby. It's weird, the stuff I remember. Okay, I don't want any of that. Take a potato. I don't want no potatoes. I don't need no meat. No pots and pans. I do want your gemstones, though, son, because those things are light and they sell really nicely. Okay, so am I feeling ballsy enough to try Halted Stream Mine with this with her right now with a hunting bow? Straight up leather armor? That bandit chief might be a handful for her. Steel shin boots? I'll take those. Guess what, Fendall? You just got an upgrade, son.
I'm right behind you.
With your sexy hairy elf legs. What?
What do you want me to carry?
Transmutation. That's what's in Halted Stream Mine, Nacho, and no, I do not have it. I am very much a fan of transmute ore. But doing that is boring as hell because I do the whole cast, wait, cast, wait, cast, wait, cast, wait, and it's tedious as hell to watch. So I'm not gonna do that on the stream. Definitely not gonna do that on the stream. Yeah, dude. Get some boots. Yeah, look at you. Stylish.
You lead, I'll follow.
You're damn right you'll follow. He's all, I got this crush on Camilla, but I'll follow you to the ends of the earth, dude, while I leave Sven in town with her by himself, you know. My master plan was so awesome that she'll never talk to him again. He'll never discover he was set up. It's like, alright, dude, whatever. Okay. So now, I guess that's it, right? Nothing in these sacks? Yeah. The sacks are drained. The sacks are empty. Yeah, you know what? Let's go ahead and get the hell out of here. Where did I get this from? Now I'll just put him on the way out to hell with it. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. Is there anything in the water? Oh, there's mushrooms over here. That's right. And another iron vein. Duh. Look at that. And that's one mod I do use a lot, too, is the one that makes the veins glow. Because it makes it easier for me to see them when they're not... when they're depleted. Even though I know they're depleted all the time. And... nothing in the water, right? Yeah, this is the remastered version, the special edition of Odio. That's what this is, that work that I'm doing. I just like it because it's Elder Scrolls, and I've been playing Elder Scrolls since friggin' Arena. So... or even before that. Daggerfall? Was it Daggerfall? God, I don't even remember the names anymore. Morrowind was the one that really made their name in this sphere. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But yeah, this is a... I mean, you know, when you go through, you follow the main quest, you do what they tell you to do, and, you know, you discover all these things and blah, 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 blah. But it's your typical standard fantasy fare. It's not, anything, put the torch back there, yeah. And then we'll go over here and put this torch back here. Sure, why not? Do I have any torches left? I don't think I do. Hunting bow, yes. And, all right, so let's get out of here. Hopefully it'll be closer to daytime. Dude, he's getting his ass kicked by a rock. He may not be the brightest follower. I may have to upgrade him. But, Evodio, in terms of understanding, like, it's just your basic main quest, you are the hero to save the world type of deal, huh? You know? I like it because it doesn't really make you do it. As long as you stay out of Whiterun, you don't ever have to worry about dragons appearing. And that has its own benefits. One of the downsides, however, is that you cannot use shouts until you unlock at least one soul. And without dragons, you cannot do that, as far as to the best of my knowledge. What have I got for inventory here? How am I doing? I got stuff I can sell. Let's see what we're doing here. But Dad, this is why I like Skyrim. I mean, look at this. Even now, this looks good. You know, I mean, yeah, they upgraded the water and the graphics and stuff like that. But they didn't make it too brutal or crushing because it still runs really smooth. Which is why it's hard to switch away from Skyrim after I've been playing it for a while, because it's so smooth. So, yeah. And Nacho, it just repeated what you just said. Is that a bug on my end? Is YouTube wigging out on me? Am I losing my thing or what? Just doing a little status check on what's going on. Bought everything in the Creation Club. Yeah, that's vanilla. For me, vanilla is what it's all about. I love the vanilla game. I just play it over and over and over because with the way the skills are done and with the way the game is structured, you could just do anything you want to. And if you have rerollitis like I do, the first levels go really quick and it's a nice smooth arc. And, you know, another thing I'm a big fan of is the UI. If you're not injured or anything, this is what you see. You see the bar at the top and that's it. It's just a very clean, immersive kind of experience. If you want to go third person to watch your character run around, you can totally do that too. But it's hard for me sometimes to maneuver when it's third person. Now, when I climb hills backwards and stuff, I'll definitely go third person so I can see the angle of the rock a lot better. But other than that, though, okay, so where are we at? We are at, yeah, like 120. Okay, so I'm going to take a little quick break here, guys. But I'm going to change of pace, since this is not, since nothing's going to happen when I'm just standing here. I'm going to leave her standing here. I'm going to put my message up. And I'll be back, you know, smoke them if you got them, refill your thing. Didn't know the message went through. Okay. No worries, Nacho. No need to apologize. I want to make sure, there's no problem that I need to be figuring out or whatever. So, going to take a quick break. Bio, smoke them if you got them. 3 to 5 minutes. We'll be right back, folks. Okay, we are back in action here. Let me go ahead and get resettled. Alright, Nacho, we'll see you later, man. I hope you see that. I hope you hear this, but if not, we'll see you in the next one, man. Hope your connection gets better. And Sin City Boy, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Cut that thing out. And now it's daytime. Now I can friggin' see, which is good. And the only thing I don't like about Riverwood is they don't have an enchanting table in this town. You got to go to that hut with that woman, and you go to her basement, she gets pissed off. I don't like that. Okay. What are we doing here? Everybody wish Sin City Boy happy birthday. It's not today, it's in a couple of days, but it's his first 29th birthday. If I have that right. What do I have in here? Yeah, I got the iron helmet. I'm at 86. I got a lot of bird capacity. You know what the hell with it? Let's just go. We don't need to sell nothing. We can just go to Bleak Falls Barrow. Bleak Falls Barrow. Come here, you. I do like the fact that the bees have a very large bounding box, so they're pretty easy to snap out of the air. Where you at, dude? I see you over here. Come here, you. Where'd you go? You went inside the tree, didn't you? Yeah, you went inside the tree. Oh, nope, there you are. Come here, you. Boink. Zip, 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 zip. And their hive is right there. Hello, beehive. Twink. Da 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 da. You're awesome. I don't know any other YouTubers. Well, yeah. I mean, I remember the things you tell me at least as much as I can with my, you know, advanced age and fading memory. But I figure somebody's going to mention something in the stream. It's important enough to them that they thought it was worth sharing. And I'm not going to, you know, I'm not going to downplay that or whatever. Plus, you know, I mean, to my advantage, I do have, there aren't that many of y'all, so I don't, there's not a ton of stuff I had to remember. But yeah, I try to remember, because like I said, I've probably mentioned this before because I repeat myself a great deal. But it's like, you all have an infinite number of things you could choose to be doing with your time, you know, and you choose to spend it here. And I appreciate it, and I'm grateful for it, and I don't take it for granted. And there's birds? Yeah, I can't shoot birds. You're supposed to be able to shoot hawks, but I've never been able to hit one. I've tried so many times. But anyway, I mean, it's important. You know, these things are important. And it's important to you, I should at least make an effort to remember it. Now, of course, sometimes I get the details wrong and whatever, and I should be able to pick two of those damn friggin' mushrooms off a tree, but whatever. Okay, so let's go ahead. Now it's daytime, I can see, and that means the bandits are going to be hating life. And that's another thing I can't wait to get, is when I'm zoomed, I can move fast. But BKB98X, I should play Bioshock. Bioshock's a hard one. It's a fun, oh, blue butterfly, oh, hang on a second, yoink, 2, 3, yay, woo. Okay, sorry. Blue butterflies are one of the things I need a lot of. Blue butterflies, I need blue butterflies, blisterwort, the glowing mushrooms and snowberries. Those are the four things I need the most of, because those are what I need for my enchanting. And and I remember that shit. See, there's a hawk right there. See him? If I were a good shot, I could totally hit him, but I'm not a good shot, so we're gonna let him go away. Keep an eye on that butterfly. Come on, come on, come on, land. Yoink. Come on. All right, there we go. Sneak. Okay, where's that wolf? There's a wolf up here, right? Come on, where are you? Doink! Da, 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 da. Groucho! Welcome back to the stream, man. And for Bioshock is very much a... It's got such a huge twist in the middle that I don't want anybody who hasn't played it to watch it and not experience that for themselves, you know? Plus, I'm not very good at it. I mean, given the 1-2 punch, yeah, I can do the basic stuff pretty good. But yeah, Bioshock, honestly, I think it's a game you should play rather than watch. Because it's just that good. It's just that good. I wasn't really a fan of Bioshock 2. But anyway. So anyway, back to the original topic. Sin City, happy birthday, man. Happy birthday. I'm not going to sing because that's something that nobody wants to hear. Especially not me. Now, and of course, the other trick too, I forgot, right? When you have a bow, right, you can only, when you have your bow drawn, you can only move this fast when you're sneaking, right? But there's a little trick. If when you're in third person, if you take the bow out while you're sneaking, you can haul ass. I mean, look at this. So this is how I cover a lot of ground very rapidly. Go into third person, unsheath my bow, and I can go at running speed with the bow out and sneaking. So if you never knew that about Skyrim, there's a little trick for you. I don't know if it works with regular weapons, I just know it works with bows, because bows and sneaking are what I do. Now we're gonna try and show off and see if I can not embarrass myself here. Because there's a bandit right up by that tree. You see him? He just faded in. And let's see if I can get the drop on him. From this distance, what do you think about there? No. Okay. Where's he going? Try it again. Okay, no. So those arrows probably fell short. See, I can't really... I have a hard time predicting the drop at very long distances like this. But there you are. And Nacho, if you're watching now, you can see why I have so much stamina. So I can track them at extreme ranges for long periods of time. There they go. We're giving up. Walking in a nice straight line. Perfect. Thanks, dude. Bam! That's going to leave a mark, my friend. And you... Now, are they going to have... That's right, I don't have the patch. See, one of the things I don't like, too, is they have that little sidestep thing where they're like Spider-Man and they can just totally zip out of the way of the arrows coming in. In the vanilla game, there's a mod that fixes that, that takes out their ability to do that, to do their mystery dodge. Leave the target, and... Oh, son! That's why I like being an archer. So when I can make those long shots, man, I feel like a total god. I'm like, yeah! Now, where did those arrows land? Did they land short or long? I think they landed short. Yeah, see, look at that. Even raised up as much as they did, it landed here. So, that's a problem. Gold, yes. Did I pick something up? I picked up a weapon here. No, I picked up another arrow. So they fell short. Even as high as it was, they fell short. So it's a learning experience, right? You learn where these things drop and where they are and where they go. Hide boots. I'm not worried about that. Get my arrow back down. Okay, so yeah, see, they didn't hit the tree or nothing. So even as high as it was, they dropped off like crazy at the end. I don't know if that's a function of a bow. But it works. Never had an interest in Bioshock for some reason. What's the Ayn Rand objectivism? Is that what the thing is called? It's a really heavy-handed treatment of objectivism. But it's a really, really good, from an art perspective and a style perspective and mood and music and theme, it's brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. 100% brilliant. Yeah, whatever. Hit you in the mouth. Oh, what? Uh-oh, this is a problem. Wow! Fendal! You beast! Dude, that's how we do. Uh-oh. Okay. So, barrel's got cabbage. I don't want cabbage. Although, you know, I do sometimes go through here and I just eat all the food all the time. And I'm like, I just ate 74 apples and 16 heads of cabbages. Man, you got to have some kind of serious gas after that. So you're farting it up. Steel arrow, gold, iron armor, iron boots, iron gauntlets. Oh, yes, you are getting an upgrade, my friend.
I've got your back.
Yeah, you do have my back.
What do you want me to carry?
Yeah, Bioshock is if you like story-based narratives, it's absolutely brilliant. Yeah, there you go, buddy. Look at that, he didn't put the iron armor on. Why did you not do that?
What do you want me to carry?
Okay, I'm taking that off you, man. I am taking that off you. What do you got? Studded armor. There you go. I want you tanky, buddy.
Lead on.
Yeah, you tank it up, son. I'm gonna drop this crap off here. Drop that in there. Okay, nothing down here. I'm pretty sure there's a chest upstairs. So let's go ahead and get my arrows back. Boink. Can't wait to get steel arrows. And I have a method. I have a trick to getting lots of steel arrows, too. It's really sociopathic and really cruel and ugly, but it's effective. It's very effective. You don't need an iron greatsword. Okay, come on, man. Let's go. You know, I wondered. This guy didn't have a shield, does he? Because he has a... Oh, he does. I'll wait till I find an iron shield. I'll probably find an iron shield down there. But yeah, look at that. Look at how pretty this is, man. I can't even. And look, there's Riverwood. You can see Riverwood from up. I can see my house from up here. Oh, that's right. I forgot about the iron on the backside, too. Let's go get that. Let's go get that, my fine young elven friend. Couldn't hide behind a shield. Yeah, no, he didn't have a lot of options there. I mean, he was banging a sword on it like he was a badass, but didn't do him much good. Oh no, stand up. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay, perfect. That's a lot faster than sitting there watching her go tink, 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 tink. Oh, so bad. So bad. Don't think that represents completely unnoticed. Well, that's the thing. You're late to the stream, Groucho, so you got to warm up. You got to get your pun engine to a high idle here, man. That's what I got to do. Now, I know there's some snowberries over here, too, so let's get those going. The only snowberries south of the Pale right there. Okay, so now we're at a disadvantage. We're going to Bleak Falls. There's like three bandits up here, and it's broad daylight. And my sneak is not... Yeah, I don't have any points. So, start off with three when you first popped in. Oh, man, I missed him. Or did I miss him? Sorry, the wind is so loud in this area that I can't think. So, okay. Back to the whole... tactic and strategy. This is the worst possible tactical position to be in, underneath your target. Like, I don't like this. So I need to find a way to get above them without them seeing me. And snowberries. Hello, snowberries. Hello, snowberries. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna cruise off down the other side here. And Fendall, of course, is not gonna be able to make this. So he's gonna be chum. He's gonna be my bait down on the bottom there. Go up here. See, now we're at their height. Yeah, buddy. That's how we do. Okay. There's no way through there. Okay. I guess you could use the wheelbarrow to scoop out the snow. Uh-oh. Shit. Yeah, this is a problem. You little fucker. Overshot the target on that one. Yeah? You like that? Bitch. Boy, my game needs some work here. Oh, that'll do him. Ooh, no, we're not doing that. Drift him right into him. Oh, he dodged. Man, are you kidding me, dude? Uh-oh, I'm getting low on health. What am I doing? Down to 38 arrows, too. This is a problem. Okay. Well, I've got my healing, don't I? Yeah! There we go, I remembered. Where are you at? Oh, man, I missed not being able to move quickly. Come on, man, I know you're behind the pole here. But you're an outlaw, so you're a little bit tougher than the rest of them. Oh, there you are. Oh, look at you getting all sneaky. Oh, man, missed the mark on that one. You're getting him right in the mouth. You like that? Yeah! Now, after spraying arrows all over the place here, let's see if I can pick up any. I gotta get a faster bow. That's what I gotta do too, man. I gotta get my ass up to Markarth. Maybe we'll do that after I do this. Oh, steel arrows. Hello. Well, those are Fendalls. Gold. Eat that. Take that. Eat that. Take that. Normally, I take the fur armor for later crafting, but I can get lots of that at any point, so I'm not terribly concerned about that being a problem at this. What the hell? They were shooting into the ground here? I need all the arrows I can get, though, guys. Sorry, but oh, Vendel must have whacked this one. Hide armor, hide boots, steel warhammer. Okay. Alrighty then. We good? Everybody cool? Everybody's dead, so I mean, there's gonna be no complaints here. Alright. Da 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 da. What? Oh. There's one of my relics of playing survival mode for so long. Whenever I hear a noise, I walked over something. Wait, what's that? Is that something I can put in my pack and use? How many arrows I got? 69? 69? Nice. Alright, time to go to Bleak Falls Barrow. With my iron arrows, man. Iron arrows. God, I need steel arrows. Yeah, I have a way to get thousands and thousands of steel arrows and thousands of gold. Alright. Okay. Hello, bandits. How you guys doing, man? Doing good? Okay. So I can get the drop on this one. Yep. Bam! It's all about the sniper build. Yeah. Skeever tail. Good for cure disease. Thank you. But yeah, again, one of the things this game does very well is the atmospherics. Just listening to the echoing of the sound and the hollow, the roaring wind through the... And that's some white noise crap right there, right? You can go to sleep listening to that. So soothing. That's right, X is all. I gotta remember that. Open X, open X, open X. This guy had a bad day. Is that an iron shield, my friend, or is that hide? Iron. Guess what, Fendal? You just got an upgrade, son.
I've got your back.
Yep.
What do you want me to carry?
I know you're an archer, dude, but you gotta be a tank for me, man, because that last guy is gonna be a pain in butt. I don't like him. There you go. Get that sword out.
You lead, I'll follow.
You damn right you're gonna follow. You know your place. Know your role, son. Following the crazy Breton. The crazy Breton. A lot of things about this game I love to death. So I may be waxing rhapsodic on it. And perfect. Flawless garnet. Wow, flawless garnet. Hello, nurse. That's pretty good loot for level 7, 8. I didn't get my arrow back. That's okay. That's okay. I looted her, right? Did I loot her? Or was I busy picking up? Yeah, she ain't got no arrows on her. Right, okay, cool. But yeah, after this, we're gonna take a trip to Markarth, man. I gotta go see if I can get my Forsworn gear. I love Forsworn gear. I love Forsworn gear. Shh. Crackling noises like the spider webs. You know what's weird, too? It's like, why aren't the spider webs not broken if that guy came through here with the claw? How'd the bandits get down here without... Nah, I don't know. Maybe I think too much. Maybe. Maybe I think too much. As if there's any maybe about it. Burns. Yeah, I'm gonna go up to the burial grounds. I'm just gonna loot all the dead people. That's not gonna give me a curse or anything, will it? No, of course not. You know, when I first played the game, all those little stones falling, I kept thinking the ceiling was gonna collapse. I'm like, oh shit. But no, it never does. And when it does, it makes a hell of a lot of noise, so you know that it's going to come down on your head. Okay. I'm earnest. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, dude. Oh, Groucho, what would I do without you? What would I do without you, man? Now, I wish that the linen wrap... See, linen wrap 3 is 2. You had to warm up. Well, I didn't catch you warming up, man. I didn't catch you warming up. I saw that one, though. You don't see it right now, but there's a crease in my forehead where I'm wrinkling my... I'm squinching my face up. And... There you are. How you doing, buddy? Doink! Yeah, he's an outlaw. He's a tough bastard. No, 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 stay away. Stay away.
I cannot best you.
Whoa, nice parkour there, dude. That was sweet. Give me your shit. Studded armor for bracers, iron arrow. I got one iron arrow back out of three. Let's go laugh. Well, I don't know if they're cheap. You're working for them, just it's not the type of work that, there it is. Okay, so y'all know how this works, right? I'm like, okay, I've got a broken one here. So it's what? Is it snake, snake, fish? Right? Yeah, it's gotta be snake, snake, fish. So let's go and make a snake, snake, fish. Snake once, and then twice, right? Yeah, one, two, two. And boink. Open sesame. I was pretty proud of myself that I actually figured out how that worked on my own. But I am not going to, I'm going to embarrass myself and tell you it took me about 15 minutes to figure out how the keys worked. I'm like, I got the key and here's the door, but I don't know what the combination is. Yeah, well, duh. It made sense afterwards, but it took me entirely too long to crack that code, and I felt really stupid afterwards. So I'm like, how do you not... Yeah, here, come here, you.
I'm right behind you. All right, what is it? What do you need?
I need you to take this.
Okay, got it. Anything else?
Oh, you didn't take it here. If I hold it down, do you
still
do
here?
No, okay, I need to do it.
All right, what is it?
Yeah, I need what you to do that. Come here, take this thing, dude.
Okay, got it.
Yoink! Perfect.
Anything
thanks,
else?
Okay. Scrolls, scrolls, scrolls. Oops, soul gem. Yay, soul gem. Now see, here's the problem. I don't have a melee weapon, right? So whenever I get into close combat, I just basically have to, I'm a tank archer. I mean, I guess I could use a pickaxe. I could use a pickaxe, right? Yeah, you know what? It's a melee weapon. Hell with it. Let's just do it. Come on, Skeeter. I'll just do it the hard way. Where'd you go? Oh, you're in there. You get stuck, buddy? Okay. Hope I didn't catch anything. Did I catch anything? I didn't come out of any bone break fever or anything, did I? No. Good. Alright. Oh wait, bone break is bears, right? These guys are something else. I don't know. Okay. Now get the bow back out. Oh, I got the level too, man. What am I doing? 160 and 110 health it is. I got one perk. Yeah. Alchemy? No, I don't want alchemy. And smithing, I need 20, right? Okay. I gotta remember this because there's a reason I don't take. There's a reason I picked the weapons and armor that I do, and that's because you can improve them with just a steel perk. Until of course they become enchanted, in which case you need 60 to do those. And that's
someone coming. Oh. You are there. Bjorn. Solene. I know I'm right ahead.
I hear you, buddy. I'm coming. I'm not a hero though, dude. I'm not a hero. I'm a sneak archer, dude. Okay. Got that clear. And the hunting bow is out, and you are... Okay, you want to do that? That's fine. Ta-da-ta. Ta-da-ta. Tank it! Fendall! Tank it, dude! There you go, buddy. Sword and board, buddy. Do it! Alright, that's... You earned your paycheck today there, Fendall. Don't leave me for RK's sake. I'm not leaving you, dude. I'm gonna murder you. Because that's what I did to everybody. But first, let's loot all the stuff that the ancients left behind. Because for some reason, their gold still spends just fine. Which I'm okay with. Anything in here? Oh, yeah, skewer tail. Lockpick. Need all the stuff I can get.
Help me out of here.
So I can figure out what to do with those skewer tails. I can make some potions, sell them, and make even more money.
Don't leave me for Arcane's sake.
Dude, you are so dead. You don't even know it yet, dude.
Get me down. Get me down. Get me out of here.
Okay, I got that. Okay. Get you out of there, son.
Get me out of here.
Do you know how bad you're gonna die?
It's coming loose. I can feel it.
We don't parlay here. Arville the Swift. You weren't that swift, were you, buddy? Hide armor, bilge bracers. See, these are 1 in 10. I don't like that. 5 in 50. Belted tunic. Yeah, I don't care about that stuff. Retrieve the golden claw. All right, we've got the golden claw. Now, we're going to go explore through the Draugr-infested ruins. What have we got here? A bunch of trash loot. A bunch of decorating loot if I ever wanted to decorate my house with morbid instruments of death. I could grab those, but for now we're just going to steal all the stuff that the ancients left behind. Because we have a lot of respect for them. I don't want to burden them down having to carry this stuff out. You know? Okay. Now it gets dangerous. I don't like the looks of this place.
Right? I don't like the looks of this.
I know you don't. But that's okay, dude. You just have to follow me and let me do the cooking. Okay, so we got a dead one here. What you got on you? Anything good? Money, money, money. Ka-ching. Such an awesome scavenger. I loot through corpses' pockets. They'll need leather bracers. Huh? Okay, gotta fix the drop here because otherwise it's gonna hit the thing. Ooh, throat dry. Hold on 1 second, folks. Here, I need to take a sip of water. Now, let's see how many corpses have stuff that are gonna give me free money. There's you. And you. Other boots. Okay, nobody's getting salty, right? Everybody's gonna be calm. Everybody's gonna be cool. We're all gonna be cool. Is there anybody else that could possibly get up? I don't think there's anybody over here. Let's see what we got. Some likely looking candidates over here, so let's just go ahead and be cool. Bone meal, golden arrow, yes. Where you at, dude? Is there one over here? No. You are. Aren't ya? Okay. Nice and quiet. Dun, 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 dun. Give me your money. Oh, look at that, I got my arrow back. Nice that I get my arrows back. I mean, they're iron, I don't really like them that much. But, yeah, excellent. Okay, Fendal?
Still here. Lead on.
Well, you're gonna trip that trap, so I'm gonna try and get past it without you hitting it. Will you follow me? Oh, you did? Look at that! Normally he hits the trap no matter what I do. You've got a waistcoat, so you can... Oh shit, Restless. This is not good. Restless is the hard ones, man. Restless is the tough ones. At least at this level in this dungeon. Yeah, none of those arrows come back. That's okay. That's alright. Fendal's looking at me like, why'd you bring me along again? Okay. Let's see, got light coming up from the left here. What have we got? There's one right there. I see ya. What? Come. There, see? And they go to the sound of the noise, see? See, now he figured it out. But, it's not gonna do him any good. Okay. Oh, there goes the blades. Okay, we'll do the blades in a minute. We need to loot some corpses here. Because I need money. Got to get paid. Got to get paid. Steel horned helmet. That's cool. You just got an upgrade, dude.
I'm right behind you. What do you want me to carry?
Now, will he wear it, or is it, will he think the iron one's better? I hope he wears it, because it looks cool. Yeah, there you go, dude.
Lead on.
He's like, I didn't sign up for this tank and crap. I'm an archer and a hunter. I'm like, yeah, whatever. You do what I tell you. Apprentice? Oh, that's fine. We can do this one. Maybe. God, these locks are so easy compared to what I'm used to. Okay. Any arrows? Nope. And money? Yep. Okay. Oh, Ancient Nord arrows, those are nice. And the Ancient Nord bows, when I first played this game, I'm like, ooh, 16 damage, sweet. I didn't know that a weapon's weight affects its draw speed, so...
I've got your back.
That was a problem. Wait here.
You go on ahead.
Yeah, I will, dude. Okay, now to do this. Line up, wait, line up, wait, line up, wait, and through. Where is my lever? There it is. A chain. It's a chain this time. Okay, Fendo. It's clear now. I don't want you dying.
Not heading yet. Out?
Follow me.
Let's get going.
Follow me. Hello, oil pot. Alright, what do we got? It's awful quiet in here. Uh oh. Playing possum. That doesn't work on my ship, dude. See, I'm not sneaky enough yet. They can still hear the arrow whistling in. They wake up just a little bit before the arrow hits them. But if I get a little bit higher sneak, that will no longer occur. They will just end up just keel over dead. You and... Okay. Wow, that thing went flying. Boom! Folding like it. Uh oh. Somebody's awake. That's not good. No. Stop. Okay. Continuing on. They really did a good job with this game, though. Art-wise and pacing and everything. It's such a good game. I love this game so much. Sorry if I'm quiet, guys. The sound it makes is just all the ambient noises, you know, the wind and the rattling and the clinking and the rocks and everything is just perfect. Plasman, how you doing? Welcome to the stream, man. How you doing tonight? We are exploring ancient crypts in search of fame, fortune, and fat loot. Doink! Da-da-da. Chisel Gang. What was the last FPS I played casually? First-person shooter? I'm doing good, Plasma, man. Thanks, man. I'm having a very, very good time with Skyrim. I really underestimate how much I miss playing this game. Last casual first-person shooter. Last first-person shooter I played casually. God, I guess maybe Borderlands? Would Borderlands count? I would be Borderlands, because most of the stuff I play is either third-person or, like, RPGs, you know? And, I guess it would be Borderlands. I can't think of another game that I played with an action component that was first-person. Huh. It's a good question. Curious. I used to play first-person shooters all the time, but that's because I used to have good eyesight and good reflexes. Now, I am don't have either of those, so I have to play more, you know, deliberately paced, methodical, you know, aim assist kind of games, I guess you could say. It, just one of those things, I guess. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And Borderlands is a lot of fun. Borderlands 2 was okay. I enjoy the goofiness of it, you know. I'm a big fan of the absurd. Medal of Honor 360. Okay. The sound's one of the best you've ever heard. Yeah, I never played Medal of Honor. I don't play Battlefield, Call of Duty, none of those. I just, you know, things like Fortnite, Overwatch, I just, I can't keep up, you know. It's too difficult for me. Excuse me, hold on one second, guys. Voice is getting kind of rattly here, so I gotta do my things. Borderlands, yeah, Borderlands, dude. The SNS philosophy, tech plus ammo capacity equals I win. And you don't need to be a better shot, you just need to shoot more bullets. Vladoff. The old, if it took more than one shot, you weren't using a Jacobs.
I've got your back.
I still remember all the call. I just thought the ads were just so perfect. They were so stupid and so
funny.
What
do you want me to carry?
But as I've noted before, I'm a big fan of absurdity. I like that kind of thing. And it's just goofy. Yeah, now you're tanking. Look at that. Look at that
lead
badass.
On.
Yeah, dude, I'm gonna do that. There's my glowing mushrooms. When I need to harvest them, I go down to that one Falmer thing, the endless pit or whatever the hell it is. And there's like 200 of them in there. Harvest these bad boys all day long. Love me my glowing mushrooms. And of course, there's a trick to harvesting them. There's always hot spots, just like the mushrooms back in Oblivion. Those little spindly ones are so hard because you had to put your cursor on the little bulb, and they're so tiny. I'm like, oh god. At least these are a little bit larger. Mark, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How about Uncharted? That's a PS4 exclusive, is it not? I am fairly certain it is. Just like The Last of Us. I've never played it. I owned a PS4 briefly for about 3 months, and then my house got broken into and burglarized, and I lost it. My old Xbox, my entire Rock Band library, because I can't download a lot of the old songs. My laptop with 10 years worth of pictures on it that I never backed up anywhere else. So I am scarred, and I'm not going to buy a PS4 again. I view that as the unlucky feature of my existence there. So, yeah, but no, I never played it. I played similar games, I guess. Racing games? Oh yeah, I used to play the crap out of racing games. Until, again, my reflexes became such that I can no longer rely on my ability to adequately, you know, pilot my cars. But the last one I played on racing games was Forza. There was, or Forza 2? Was it Forza? No, Forza 3. I'm sorry. Forza 3 was the last one I played. I do enjoy open-world driving games, and I have considered buying or picking up or renting Horizon. Which way was I going? I was going this way. But in general, my favorite driving game, if this does not date me too much, was Need for Speed Porsche Unleashed. Porsche Unleashed was my, or that or Hot Pursuit. Those are my two favorite Need for Speed games. Because for my sensibilities, my driving, the way I think a driving game should work, those two just nailed it. They had the right balance of realism and arcadeism. Arcade physics. Because sometimes, I mean, a realistic driving game is cool. I mean, I get that. It's fun. But there's something to be said for cars that are just a little bit too grippy, a little bit too quick, a little bit too whatever. You know? I don't know. Different kind of thing. Oh, now I got stalkers? You guys are stalking each other on my channel? Oh, that's sweet, dude. But Mark, if he saw you doing it, dude, you're not that good of a stalker. I'm just going to put that out there. Sneak increased. Okay, something's out here. Oh boy. What have we got here? 2000? Yeah, dude, I told you I've been gaming a long friggin' time, dude. A long time. And actually, here's a little throwback here. I actually have the Logitech Force feedback wheel that was so good with it. The one with the little red one with the rubber thing and the pedals. Yeah. Still have that bad boy in a box somewhere. It probably doesn't even work. I don't even know where the hell you get drivers or a 20-year-old piece of equipment. But I used to have the Mad Cat's, the joystick trackball combination thing. I don't know what it was called. And I had one of the first Razer mice, you know, with the 800 DPI or whatever the hell it was back then, with the special mats that had the little, micro pattern on them so you could get ultra precision and, yeah, Jesus, God, those were the days. The Assassin, was that what it was called? The steering wheels? Not the Mad Cats thing. I may still have that in a box somewhere. I just remember how heavy the damn thing was, man. Because the base had a huge weight in it, so it wouldn't slide around on your desk. And of course, back in the days before mice were super precise, we used to have mouse pads that were like the size of a sheet of paper. They were just gigantic mice, so you could crank your sensitivity up. Can't kill me. Spy Hunter? Spy Hunter is not really a driving game, I wouldn't think. Do I remember Test Drive from PC? Dude, I remember hard driving the arcade, the Atari cabinet game. The first game of force feedback with the heavy polys, man, and the real physics, and you couldn't do the loop-to-loop until you practiced the shit out of it because the car just didn't want to behave. Yeah, I remember that. It's the strangest things you guys talk about that make me remember shit. You guys, I don't know. You make me feel old now. Well, I am old. Excited bike. Yeah, excited bike. Super sprint. I was a super sprint kind of guy. Love spinning that wheel, man. Oh, boy. Okay. Fendall, guess what?
Still here.
Take a break, buddy.
You go on ahead.
Yeah, I think I will. Thanks. Now I'm going to do my trick where I go sideways. Lining up on the center. And go. And go. And go. Okay. Everybody's cool? Alright, Fendall, it is now safe for you to proceed. Top Gun arcade machine, yeah. That, I never really liked the Top Gun arcade machine. I like the Top Gun pinball.
Let's get
big fan of the Top Gun pinball. And Road Rash, yeah, it's Road Rash, Space Harrier. God, Space Harrier. Space Harrier was fun. And Xevious, the 3D isometric shooter where you could actually change your elevation, which was bizarro. Oh my God, dude. Yeah, I see you. Are you close enough to that? Let's find out. Doink! Boom! Nah, you moved too far away from it. Damn it. Come on down them stairs, you little shit. I know you're gonna... Oh, he's on fire. Oh, there he goes. Hey! Come on, buddy. I know you're up there. Oh, there you are. Doink! Yeah, that's how we do it. Didn't even have to zoom, baby. I need a good loot here. I got that. Xevious? Yeah, whatever it was. It was like you went from the bottom left to the top right and you were going over like this futuristic cityscape or whatever when your little ship. And you had this weird, and it would strafe left really, really hard. Straight left and right. So, Xevious, yeah. God. So good, I'm not the only old guy in here. This makes me feel a little bit better, guys. Needs to be a little bit better. Let's all take a trip down memory lane when we come home. Coming home smelling like popcorn and having the token smelling dirt on your fingers from those brass ass tokens. Oh God. Back in the day, the tokens. Tokens. Alright. No loot here. Any loot here? No loot there. No loot there. Place is kind of dry, but we're okay. We're moving along. You've got arrows, good. Bone meal, garnet, gold. Wow, you got a lot of stuff on you. Doctype, how you doing, man? Welcome to the stream. You're at work? All right, well, I will try not to distract you with my pointless babbling and meandering. How about we do that? We are currently in Bleak Falls Barrow. We have cleaned out the Amber Shard Mine. We have exploited our way up. We have exploited our way up to 50 bow by... stealing my training cash from Fendall there. I tanked his ass up because he's going to tank the dude at the end. We're just basically doing Bleak Falls Barrow here. getting near the end. I think we're in the sanctum. No, the sanctum, not yet. Okay. So here we are. Oh, there's that sound. Dong. Yeah, here we go. Here we go. Now, I'm going to see if I remember this. I think it's just 111, right? I'm just going to guess, see if it works. Back away from the doors in case there's any darts or flames. Oh, no, it wasn't it. Okay. So what's the pattern? What's the pattern? The pattern is... How do I zoom? Can I zoom? No? No, I can't zoom. Or I forgot how. One of the two. How do you zoom? I thought you could zoom. I mean, I know you can rotate it, right? Have I played Ark Survival Evolved? No, I have not. Should I? I mean, what's the hook on it? So it's Bear Moth Owl. It's Bear Moth Owl. So it's 2 and 2, right? Bear Moth. Yeah, it was 2 instead of 1. So what is Ark Survival Evolved? If you can give me a short synopsis. What kind of game is it? Is it RPG? Is it, do you think it's the type of game I would like, based on what you've seen and on the channel and what I've talked about and what preferences I've expressed and the like? Wow, would you look at that? I wish there was something in here, but there's not. Okay. Would you look at that? Alex, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. How you doing tonight, man? Da-da-da. Say it. Say it, dude. Come on.
Wow. Would you look at that?
It's an online game. Tame and capture animals. Oh, okay. I would not have ever played Ark then. Chiseled gang. And hi, Don. How you doing? Welcome to the stream. Started playing Far Cry. It's really good. Okay, excellent. Excellent. Did you like the, Alex, did you like the earlier Far Cries? I mean, is it similar to those types of things? Come on, man. I need to see here. I can't see. Oh, come on. I know I can get up there, dude. There we go. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay. Lock picking ahoy. Yeah, look how easy these lock picks. These locks are so nice. So nice. Oh, gold necklace too. Good. Use that for later on to do my enchanting. Okay, Fendal, guess what, dude? You are going to be bait, my friend. I need you to come over here for me, son. Come on over here. Fendal, come on.
I'm right behind you. Lead on. I've got your back. You go on ahead.
Wait here. Okay. Anything good in here? Okay, out we go. Let's learn our word. Up. Yeah, I know, dude. You know it's me, but that's the thing. Fendal's right there. So, he's gonna tank like a bee. Oh, shit. He went down a lot faster than I was expecting. Whatever, dude. Fine. Yeah, you can't get up here, can you, little shit? Come on. Look at him dance. Oh, I staggered him. Look at that. I know I can stagger him. Perfect. There we go. Thanks, Vendal. All right. Good. All done. Yay. All done. Whee. Grab this thing and this thing. Anything in here? No? Just linen in there, right? Am I gonna go with a bow in real life? I used to be. I used to be a very long time ago. I no longer am. I have since switched to pistols. Nah, I'm not gonna deal with that. Yeah, I'm just. Evodio, the first time I did this, I went by myself, and he kicked my ass. But I
Let's get going.
But I just abuse my followers. I'm like, whatever, dude. You stand there, take it for the team. I don't give a crap. I'm just gonna do this, and we're going to. You're going to have to deal with that, my friend. So, yeah. What kind? Chisel Gang. I'm assuming you're talking about pistols. I'm a big fan of 9mm, and I am very much a fan favorite of the Springfield XD Mod 2. That is my current weapon of choice. Now, with that said, I have not had an exhaustive I do not have exhaustive experience with these particular types of machines, but I did try a good 15 or 20 of the most popular nines to decide which was the most comfortable, which was fit the way I wanted, had the features I wanted, it's easy for me to operate. And it suits my style and my grip and everything else. So, but yeah, anything bigger than a 9, I have problems keeping it on target when I am rapid, even double tapping. I can't bring it back down fast enough. My wrists are not. I mean, I guess I could improve my wrist strength, but it's just I prefer to use a tool that I am comfortable with. You know what I mean? Yeah, see, Glocks make me nervous because they ain't got safeties, you know. Not that there's anything, you know, 100% effective or whatever, but if it keeps me from making obvious mistakes, I am all for it. And I do like the way the Glocks shoot. I like their action and I like the recoil. It's very, very nice. If I were to ever get better or more comfortable with weaponry in the main, in the general and the specific, I would probably look into buying one as a backup. But for now, I am very satisfied with my current level of comfort, quote, expertise, and proficiency. That's the word I'm looking for, proficiency. Better to have an underpowered tool I know how to use than an overpowered one I don't. You know what I mean? Isn't there a vein around here? Yeah, and I did. Those are two entirely different grip profiles. So, yeah, wow. Definitely, definitely, definitely. Where's my pickaxe? Okay. Can't really use Corundum yet, but that's okay. I'll just get it for now. It's just going to take up space in my bag. Isn't there another one? There's just one, right? Yeah, just one. I thought there was another one down here. And see, that's one of my companions. They used to sneak in when I hear footsteps. I'm like, oh shit, what's that? It's like, oh, that's my guy. Is it here? There we go. Is this modded? No, it is not. I'm just going straight vanilla, Doc. This is what this is what I call the palate cleanser. You know, I just wanted something that's Bethesda, but not Fallout for a while. And something that was not, you know, State of Decay. Because State of Decay is... I still play it, I still enjoy it, but it's not a streaming kind of... It's not something that's fun to watch, I don't think. It's fun to play, but it's not really fun to watch, I don't think. And this might be fun to watch. But if I do mod it later on, I'll just be getting, like, the unofficial patch and... the mod that makes enemies not do that slip dodge, and the one that lights up ore veins. You know, the stuff is that. Mindless is good, yeah. Sometimes, especially after a hard day, especially after a long day at work, where I have been doing too much thinking, too much deciding, too much planning, I just want to crack open a beer and just smash a zombie head. It's like something simple, something easy, something I can handle, you know, like whatever. And, yeah, so, for me, what is that? So, what is that picture of, Mark? I mean, the keyboard's on the other laptop. I'll look at it later, but give me a preview of what we were talking about here. I'm assuming this is weapons related, because that's what we were just discussing. Here's your shag. Oh, take pity on an old woman.
I'm just a poor old woman, dear. No need to trouble yourself with me.
Yeah, you look like a hag, girl. You are like two steps away from being
it's
a hag, Raven.
It's just scraping by out here, but I make do.
Oh, Zevius, nice! Nice! Went back a little bit further than the conversational tree. I see, okay. Misty here, okay. I'm pretty sure Riverwood is this way. We're just going to keep going. We're just going to keep going. If we get lost, we get lost, because my character doesn't have to eat or sleep. So, oh, there's the icon. Okay, we're getting close. La-di-da-di-di-di-da. Oh, a rabbit! Quick! I don't need a rabbit hodge. Dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. Oh, plants. And see, that's the thing, too. With this type of lighting, everything gets washed out, and I can't see the plants, which is unfortunate. Oh, here's the back way up to the back way up to, yeah, I keep going in on a third person because in State of Decay, the run button is the left shoulder. Hello, rabbits. I'm not hungry, so you're okay. Yeah, here's those iron ore veins. Okay, that's where I'm at. Okay, cool. Go back the way I came here. But yeah, stairs are just going to nowhere. Oh, it's snowing. Oh, it's snowing. Thank God I'm not playing on survival. I'd be freezing to death right about now. Okay, is my bow strong to bring down this? Oh, no. Damn it. Are you kidding, dude? Slow drawn bow. No, you don't. Need the meat. Need your hide. Give me some of that. Give me. Thank you. Deer hide and venison, but no arrow. But that's okay. I've got... How many do I have? Oh, I only got 44 left? Oh, jeez. I've been blowing through arrows. Do they have survival in Skyrim? Yes. They added it... Bethesda added it later on. It's fairly recent, right? When they released Creation Club? Was that when they pulled it out? I tried it. It's weird. I'm so used to the Fallout 4, you know, method of doing it that I died a couple times before I could even get a grip on what the hell I was supposed to be doing. Ooh, slaughterfish eggs. Yay. But yeah, it's you get cold. That's what it is. You get exposure. And you have to wear certain types of You need hot food or certain types of armor or clothing or whatever to not freeze to death. And while that's a cool dynamic, I don't know. It's hard for me to really take it seriously because how exactly is wearing fur armor going to help an Argonian? They're reptiles. They don't generate their own body heat, right? They're not mammals. So what good is it going to do him? And for that matter, how the hell do Argonians even survive out here in the first place? But that's a discussion for another time. I'm sure there's a lore answer that suits. Here we go. Let's go turn in our... And you know, I just realized I have fast travel. Uh-oh.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only.
Let's see here.
Ah, a letter from the Jarl. Moving up in the world, eh? Looks like that's it. Got to go.
Nope. Sorry. Nothing.
Nope. Sorry.
Oh, he didn't say nothing. Damn. Is there anywhere in this game you can get a beer? Oh, hell yeah, man. I can go down to the Sleeping Giant Inn? You can buy mead. You can buy Haunting Brew and Blackbriar. Is it Sleeping Giant Inn? Yeah. Sleeping Giant Inn, right here. Goodbye, beer. What race class? I am Breton, and I am currently playing a Stealth Archer. There's a shocker. Right, Doc? yeah, I like the Bretons. I like the Bretons a lot because, well, if I can remember which button to press. Because I like them because they're tiny. I mean, she's even, look how small she is. She's even smaller than him. And he's a high elf. So, yeah, I like playing sneaky archers. Just because I love the physics and the mechanics of the archery in this game. In that it's sort of a learned skill, you know? And I'm pretty good at it. I've had a lot of practice with it. I still miss, you know. But I like it. Let me see what the letter from Falkreath. Yeah, whatever. Sidgear. The fame of my exploits, dude. This dude is such a tool. Oh, I'm just going to sit here and get drunk and my dad's locked in the cage or whatever. You're a punk ass, dude. Ooh, salt. Use that. I play as a Breton. Yeah, the reason I play Breton number one is because they're smaller.
I'm glad to help any way I can.
I find it amusing. I mean, look how big Gerder is next to her. I mean, she's gigantic, right? Even with my helmet, I'm only come to her shoulder.
A fine day to you, friend.
Yeah, that's what's up.
With a sword in your hands.
But two, I like you do that in real life, but you're very whoa, Mark, just bombing us with the TMI bombs here, huh? But two, I like the racial skills that are passive. I like passive skills because active skills I always forget to use. And 25% magic resistance, dude. Get the 25% magic from that. You go get the Blessing of Mara for another 10%. And then later on, I'll go get, what is it? Which one is it? The Lord one that gives you more magic? Basically, I get to the point where with two items, I can have like 60% magic resistance. And I'm just like, I am good with this. Let's wait. We need to wait, right? Hang on, let me do this. I'm not going to speak to the Jarl of Falkreath. We're not doing any sort. We're going to go do the Golden Claw. Are we open yet? We are. It's 1 o'clock in the morning and they're open? The hell is this? Hey, Lucan, how you doing? That's it. I can't believe it. It's smaller than I remember.
Show those. The sooner you find... You found it.
There it is.
Strange. It seems smaller than I remember. Funny thing, huh? I'm going to put this back where it belongs. I'll never forget this. You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
I may have played this game a little bit too much. Now, of course, the first time I did it, I accidentally stole it when I was trying to talk to him. So I learned very quickly to go behind him. And see, now I can take this money. And then she'll sometimes say, oh, good thing that was just left lying around. I'm like, well, yeah, it's you're my friends. I'll take all your shit. Fendall's bored. Oh, excuse me, Lucan. Can you? Thank you. I don't want to accidentally steal something, man, because that's... Take the potions, yes. I don't want to steal that. I'll take this. Because I need money. And I need these arrows, too. God, I need arrows. Okay. Search. No, not steal from chest. We're not stealing anything. Because I don't want those damn hired thugs to come after me. I hate those hired thugs at early levels. Later on, they're funny. But at first, they are more than a handful. And I have died to them far too many times. Because they are way, way overpowered. Especially for a sneaky archer when I can't tank them. Alright. Food. Let me eat that rabbit haunch. I'll just eat a raw rabbit leg. I'll eat the venison because why not? Okay, Fendall?
I'm right behind you.
I need to trade some things with you.
What do you want me to carry?
I don't want you to carry nothing, dude. I want to take everything off of you. Give me this, this, and this, and this, and that, and the steel horn helmet, and the shin boots, and the gauntlets, and the iron arrows, and the steel sword of frost. Right? Okay, you still have all the stuff that you had, and you have these two books that I will learn later, and I'll deal with it. Okay.
Let's get going, then.
I'm going to sign the part.
I've got your back. I'll head back home if you need me.
Okay, you do that, man. Your follower leaves your service. Thank you. Okay, Lucan, you have any more money? Are you open?
Thank you so much. Take a look.
Oh, he restocked his money. Excellent. Let's go ahead and sell these scrolls and these potions. Get rid of that stuff first. Yeah, speech increased. Sub tomatoes. I need those. Don't need the bounty. Don't need the letter. Did I learn that yet? I don't think I know that spell, do I?
Alright then. Okay. You and me, we're the only people around who aren't complete. Some may call this junk. I call them treasures.
Yes, I call them treasures. Staff of the familiar 307. He didn't even have 307. Okay. I got 2,900. What have you got on you? Did you restock your inventory? Do you have anything good? Conjuration Rush. Oh, look at this. Bam! Score like a boss. That is exactly what I needed and what I wanted. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Iron armor boots, gauntlets, iron helmet, iron shield, silver ring, steel armed helmet. Get rid of all that. Get rid of those. Oh my god, I got so many of those. We'll sell... nine of them, yeah. I hope I can get all this stuff back, man. Oh yeah, here we go. Common soul gem. Flawless garnet. Oh, I shouldn't sell these, man, but I need the money. I'll craft them later. I'll worry about it later. Ruby. Petty soul gems. Yeah, I don't need these right now. I don't have soul traps, so we're not going to worry about that. But my god, did I score? Oh my god, I scored on that one. Oh yeah, gold necklace. Let's sell that too. Only 40 though? Really? Only 40. Okay. Alright. Good. Excellent.
Till next time.
Okay, you gotta gain Far Cry 5. Yeah, I've been wanting to. Mark, do you play it? Do you stream it? Or are you just playing it to play it? Because if you stream it, I would definitely like to watch it. Wow, looks like you had a food explosion up here. Let's just be a dork. Yay. Can't take me anywhere.
Riverwood Trader is everything you need in a general store.
Yes, I know. I know it is, dude. I'm going to do some bread booting. Bread booting. Ta-da-da-da. Easily entertained? Have I mentioned that? No? Now, see, it's... I don't want to unlock because it'll probably think I'm stealing. But I can take these, yes, gold and gold, yes, take the gold, unlock, I'm not unlocking the chest. Yeah, dude, how you doing? What's up? Personal space? Yeah? No? Okay, cool. You're making episodes? None on the channel yet. Alright, let me know when they hit the channel, dude. I wanna see these things, because I haven't liked any of the previous Far Cries except Primal, but five sounded really interesting. So I have been wanting to eventually at least watch somebody that I know playing it, you know, to give commentary, to give me some, you know, like not like a review, but like feedback and shit. But I want to be sure that it's not going to be too Twitch reliant, I guess you could say. Best way to describe it. No. Do that. Let's get out of there. Can I upgrade my armor? Probably not, right? Yeah, no. Can't really do any of that. Oh my god, my spending is so low. Need to make some stuff, so let's make some stuff. Okay, now here you do the math. 1, 2, 3 is 12? Yeah, 3 is 12. We'll do that. 3 is 12, so we need 3. Doing 3-4 conversion math in my head. We need 1, 2, and 3. Yep. Episode 1. That dude, it's fine. We were all new, dude. You saw my earliest videos. Come on now. It ain't gonna be worse than my earliest stuff, dude. So, you're all right, man. You're all right. Just have fun with it. Enjoy what you're doing. The rest of it's just details, man. And no, man, don't. I'll watch it when everybody else does, dude. I want you to publish stuff, man. I want to see the cool shit. Okay, 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, almost made it. I don't have any. Yeah, I don't got none of this shit. Okay, so now I got a choice to make. I got a choice to make. What we're gonna do first, I think, is. What time is it? 3:23? Yeah, you know what? Let me just go into the inn here, and I'm going to go ahead and take a quick bio really quick. A quick bio really quick, he said redundantly. And then I'm going to try and get ambitious in the last, what do we got, half hour? Wow, we're going through this.
What are you staring at?
I ain't staring at nothing, you lush. Get the hell out of here, dude. Shut up. Okay, folks, I'll be back. Oh, God, the cat's making noise. Hold on, I got to go check that out. I'll be right back, folks. I don't know how long. Hold on, be right back.
Yes?
Just being stupid. He wasn't getting into stuff more than he normally does. He's pretty spry for a 14-year-old cat, I gotta tell you that. So what are we gonna do now? What's my burden? Let's do a little bit of, let me adjust these headphones here. Let's do a little bit of maintenance, see what we got going on. We're at 123, so I've got plenty of space to pick stuff up. I have a lot of plants on me. We are in the... Yeah, we're here. You know what? Let's go through here and do a little bit of a ingredient chowing and just eat the stuff that I have not eat. Unknown. I know what you do. I know what you do too, and I need something else that's weird with you, and I don't remember what it was, but we'll eat it anyway. Garlic. Eat you. And yeah. Sure. And what else? Eat that, eat this. And you.
Yeah.
Okay. This is Riverwood, yeah. We're in the Sleeping Giant Inn. I just went back, turned in the quest, and then I wanted to go somewhere safe. JPEG, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. Dude, everything's bad for you in this game, pretty much. A lot of this stuff just damages stamina. But it's only brief when you eat the raw ingredient, so it's not so bad. But I want to get, I think it's snowberries. I want to say it's snowberries and it's blue. I want to say it's this one. Yes. Okay, it's enchanting. And then the other one is blisterwort and something else. So. it's the game of day, sorry. No problem, man. No problem. We are all good in the hood, my friend. Yeah, look at that. Boom, boom, boom. That's my moneymaker right there. Resist frost. Right? Yeah. Do that. Do these. Do our known moneymakers, and then we're going to do a little experimentation. The bee and the butterfly wing do nothing. Right? Nope. Blue mountain flower? Nope. Rabbit stamina? Whatever, dude. But alchemy increase, so... Sure. Okay, so we're out of those. Blue butterfly wing. What am I enchanting? And smithing is blisterwort and glowing mushroom, right? Yeah. So we're gonna save those. Wow, that's a nice one. Oh, that does resist fire too. Wow. How about this? No? And yeah, sure, why not? Plamonita and garlic? Nothing. See, two mushrooms won't do anything, I don't think. So I gotta be careful about trying those combos. Salt pile? Nope. Plamonita and skivertail?
Nope.
I do like it that it grays out the ones you tried in the same session. So you don't sit there and just, okay, white cap flaming is not going to fly. So, no, and no. Da-da-da. I'm not getting any, not getting any of the juice here. Oh, wow, that was a waste. Well, that's nice. Okay, good. So now we are done. Now we're going to go damage health and see what we got. Yeah, two. Whatever. Ravage Magicka is only 29. Yeah, so I got nothing. What the hell? I'll just do this one. Why not? Make the monies. Make the monies. The Elf Companion. Quit Alchemy, yes. Mark says that Elf Companion get into training to archery and take your money back. So I can get my archery up to 50, right? Yes, I know the Fendal trick, dude. The Fendal trick is the reason I like making archers, man, because it's like I can get to that stagger thing right away, and I'm like, yep. There's all kinds of little bits and pieces that I still actually kind of retain about this game here. I got to figure out what I want to do with my next perk. I think I'm going to go for smithing, because steel is my jam. Yeah, we've been playing for, what, 2.5 hours? I'm level 9 already. Okay, so we've got this. Well, yeah, what I did is I came down, Mark, and went and cleared Amber Shard Mine with Fendal. And then, yeah, I'm sneaking all over the place. I'm having Fendal skill me up, and then we did Bleak Falls Barrow. So that did me, that gave me a pretty good chunk of, change. And now we're loaded down. What's my burden? 117. Okay, so good. We're a third. And I need to go this way. So now we're going to do some traveling. We're going to go to Whiterun. Did not love this game. Nope. I know, JPEG. That's why I'm playing it. I want to see if maybe I can get you to experience it in a different way. To where maybe you'll like it. I don't know. If not, I just needed a palate cleanser from Fallout 4. I need to try something different. But something that's Bethesda, because I do like Bethesda games. And we're going to skip our, that's all good, dude. Like, it's like some people like some games, some people don't, you know. There's a lot of games that are super popular that I tried. I'm like, nah, this ain't my thing. This doesn't do anything for me. But I spent entirely too many hours in here because this feeds my rerollitis. It feeds my Exploration Jones. It's very, I did loot him. Okay, I was going to say, I better have looted him. But it allows me to play the game any way I want to, and don't much like first-person melee. We'll just go third-person. Did you try the third-person melee? Whenever I melee, dude, I immediately go third-person. I can't do first-person melee at all. But yeah, if you watched the stream earlier, you'll watch when we were doing the melee parts, third-person all the time, because I can dance around. I can see what's going on, you know? I'm playing this because JPEG isn't a fan. Well, I want to see if maybe seeing it, experiencing it in a different way will make it more attractive. I mean, maybe it won't. I don't know. But it can't hurt. Besides, I love playing this game. I mean, dude, I'm not kidding you. One character I played, I never went to Whiterun, right? I never unlocked the dragons or nothing. I would just log in, get him out, right? Because I did get the DLC, so I got the house in Morthal. That's my favorite house, the one that's up by Solitude. And I would just come down to Whiterun like I am right now. Detected? What? Oh, the guard. And I would just sit here and hunt the plains of Whiterun. I'd run from Whiterun to Rorikstead, go up to the North Mountains, go down south to where the dragons, the hills go up to where the Fort something. And I would just, I'd hunt elk. I would just hunt elk. It was just fun. Soothing, relaxing. Skin them. Make stuff. Make leather armor. Sell it. Buy arrows and just go back out and do it again. Just sit there and hunt elk and learn to shoot for like 3-4 hours a night, man. Just like whatever. Oh, I'm totally busted, JPEG. I have no ulterior motives whatsoever, man. I will put them right the hell out there. But I mentioned earlier in the stream too, is it's not like it's a secret. But you never know. Like sometimes I've seen people play a game and they play it a way I didn't consider, and I'm like, huh, maybe I want to try that now. And I would try it, I'd still not like it, but at least I tried something new. It's like, eh, you know, it ain't bad. But yeah, pick plants and just shoot elk and just run around and it was soothing. Turn the music way the hell up and just kind of chill. Have a couple glasses of wine and just kill elk. It was just, I don't know, man. It was just fun. But if you want to go hardcore, I can go there with a couple of daggers and just go ape shit and go try and kill Draugr. Like, yeah, whatever. Uh-oh, blue butterfly. Come here. Don't move. Tundra cotton, yay. Oh my god, look at all the butterflies. Ooh, booyah. Booyah, booyah. Those guys are the hardest to get. Well, Blisterwort's a pain in the ass, too. But once I can grow it, it's not so bad. Once I can get, did I really mention me? What? Yeah, man. Well, because you mentioned that you didn't like it, you know, you just couldn't get into it or whatever. And, I mean, it's not like I'm doing it's like, this is not like the let's convince JPEG to play Skyrim. This is like, I'm going to play Skyrim anyway, but hey, while we're at it, let's see if JPEG drops by and maybe we can, maybe convince him to give another go. Maybe look at it in a different way, or not. You know, it's a net gain. Everybody wins. I like everybody wins scenarios. Okay, Whiterun stables discovered. Okay, so now we're going to be really stupid, and we're going to try something that I probably will not be able to get away with, but I have to try it. I have to try it because this is my jam. This is my jam.
Need a ride? Capital. Where do you want to go?
My best boy. Dude, that's Mark. That's like saying, dude, you gotta try heroin. Dude, you like it. Yeah, you hated it before, but trust me, it's different this time. Mark, no. 76 Mark is a non-starter. You can save yourself a lot of time, dude. Because it's not a question of
climbing back and we'll
like
be
or
off.
Dislike. You know what I mean? So it's all good. Pulled up one of my butt. And see, now, Doc, when you say something like that, that's kind of nerve-wracking because, I mean,
don't believe a word of it.
You know, given your line of work, pulling something out of people's butt is a scenario that's not unheard of. At least from the stories I've heard, right? Okay, it is nighttime, and nighttime is definitely not the right time. But I'd be amazed. Oh, I do. I've seen stories. I mean, let's do a little waiting here. I need to wait for the morning time. There's a couple of websites that actually every year they publish a list of the top 10 things that were pulled out of people's posteriors. Oh, Groucho. Dude. Adam Sandler? Okay, I must have made a reference that I didn't, that I'm not, That's the problem with getting your social reference, cultural references through osmosis. I often hear things that are funny, but I don't have a context for them. I don't know where they came from or what they mean. I just know how they're used. So I'm like, ah, cool. So I can blend.
What happened to you, Pop?
The Forsworn have taken Kolskager Mine.
Kolskager Mine. Left. Amarin, divine smile on you, friend.
Go inside and get some rest. I'll send word to the Jarl.
Thanks. Send word to the Jarl.
Damn Forsworn. Seems Kolskager Mine got hit by four. Fiercer than I could have imagined. Pavo and Gat are the only survivors. I'm sure Pavo would be great.
Oh, nighttime is right. Okay.
And we'd all rest a little. But that's nonsense. You can't handle a group of Forsworn by yourself. If their axes don't get you, their magic will.
We had your song.
Guess we'll have two more mouths to feed for a while.
Yeah, whatever, dude. You're fine. You're fine. Now, I don't necessarily need Kolskager Mine. I don't need to clear this out. But I just want to kill... Yeah, it's a song. That's the reference I have of it. See, that's what I get for being a cultural throwback. Oh, look, Potatoes. I don't care about potatoes. I want chicken eggs. Give me the eggs. Give me the eggs. Okay, what do I need? Wheat. Wheat. That's what I always get at these places, but you don't have any wheat here. Hanging moss? No, that's not moss. That's just decoration. What's up, big guy? What's up, man? How you doing?
Oh, I've lived through rebellion, forsworn, undead, witches, wizards, hag ravens, and marriage.
Da-da-da. Okay. So now we're going to see one of my other glitches, exploits, whatever. I think they fixed this one, but I don't think they fixed Dawnstar. Okay, I don't know if y'all know this. You probably do if you play this game enough. But the vendors in this game have a chest in the game where their inventory is. Right? All the wandering traders, all the guys in here. Come here, butterfly. Oh, Khajiit has wares. Okay. But on a couple of places, the chests are really close to the surface. One of those places is behind this wall. Now we're going to see if I can see it, if it's still here. Not the chopping block. Is it still here? Or is the chopping block covering it? Because I know it's like it was right over here somewhere, and they fixed... they What's this? So here's the thing, right? Here's the road, comes down from Markarth. It takes a left, then you go down here, then you look down here, and the chest is right there. And in this chest, it's a ton of shit. So if you want to get rich really quick, guys, here's how you do it. There's one here, and there's one in Dawnstar. Now, I thought they had fixed this. And see, I am tempted as hell to grab this thing right now. Okay? You don't even know how tempted I am to grab this. So there's one here and there's one in Dawnstar. I'm going to grab this. I'm going to show you guys. I'll show you these two things really as a thing. But yeah, I'm going to leave this alone for now. But it respawns every... I'm going to take these though. It respawns. It always has 750 gold. And the chest respawns... James, how you doing? Welcome to the stream. So it was the app that has the chat involved. Excellent. How you doing, man? We're going to be... Oh, God. We're going to be quitting here pretty quick. It's 2:54. But I'm having fun because I love this friggin' game. So we're going to keep going. But yeah, this is where I go to farm my... I go to these chests to grab all the magic items and crush them to learn enchanting. I grab all the potions to sell. But I usually leave most of the stuff around. There's one in white right outside the walls. Yeah, that one, Russell, you kind of have to go underneath the world to get at it, though, right? Isn't there a way you have to sort of glitch through the world to get at that one? There's like two or three of them right underneath the ground, right? But there's this one. There's one in Dawnstar by the first mine. The one in Dawnstar is easy to find because you can triangulate on the rocks. But what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cheese ball it. Man, I'm cheap. I don't care. I'm going to put my new hat on and my arm. Oh, God, yes. Oh, yes. Now is my bow do. Now my bow does 30. Wow, that's pretty good, I guess. Watching the stream. Well, good, man. Thank you very much for the kind words, James. Thanks for stopping by, man. I love when people can hang out. And where is Kolskegger Mud? It's over there. Okay, so we're going to try and get ourselves a bow here. We're going to try and get ourselves a bow. The two I know of that you can get just by crouching are the ones here and in Dawnstar. And between those two, I mean, I can usually farm like crazy. But I don't normally need them. So I leave them there until I'm starting to skill up enchanting or I need materials. That's when I really grab, is when I go to skill up. When I need ore and leather and, you know, stuff like that, I'll grab those things. But I usually go after them until I have a house. Okay, so now we are going to mess with... How many arrows do I have? I got 48 arrows, huh? I got 48 arrows, and we're going to do the Forsworn. Oh, God. But there's only like three of them down here. So we're going to go ahead and be real cool here, folks. Because Forsworn are like children of Adam. They are very overpowered. They are very, very twitchy. They have what you call heightened senses. And they can detect sneak from a long way away. Uh, They're obnoxious? The Forsworn are obnoxious? Groucho, is that what you're talking about? I love the Forsworn. But mostly because I play female characters for the largest part, and their armor is awesome. IG senses? No, they're IG senses. I'd already be detected. But yeah, there's a couple of them. There's one on the bridge, and there's one down here on the left by the chicken place. I just got to be super careful here. See, there she is right there. Can I get the drop on her from here? Can I hit her? Well, she's attacking something. Something on the bridge. What's going on? A rabbit? She's chasing a goat? Yeah, she's chasing a rabbit. Okay, there's one right there. I see you. Don't get excited. How old is this character? Yeah, new playthrough, dude. 2 hours. A little over 2 hours old. Okay, we're gonna hit that guy. Ready? Pop! Yeah! Got him in one, bitch! Ow! Doesn't have a bow, though. Oh, it's a chicken. Okay. So there's one Forsworn down. I don't have to worry about the guy in the heights. Uh-oh. There you go. Look at that shit! Oh, that's so bullshit! Such bullshit! That Spider-Man... No, you don't. No, you don't. So if I do install mods, that is the first mod I'm installing, guys. That is the first mod I'm installing. Is the one that, yeah, whatever, dude. How do I stand up? Here we go. Yeah, you keep shooting, bitch. Your arrows suck. Yeah, I'm a better shot than you, muff. Where you at? Okay, you're over here. So, yeah, this character's like 2 hours old. Well, 3 hours old now. But she can take out Forsworn if I can get him from stealth, man. One shot, boom, with an iron arrow. So that's sort of nice. Okay, come on, I'm hiding. Yeah, sneak increase, which means it's going down. Come on, go down. And see, that guy's got a bow. And that's...
You can't hide from me forever.
Yeah, I can, dude. And I'm not going to hide from you forever, dude. It's going to hide from you long enough for you to give up. Come on.
Oh, well. Must have run off.
Yeah, maybe not, dude. Where are you going? You going back down the path?
I'm going to find whoever did this, and when I do...
Huh? See, look at that. He alerted already, dude. I'm just standing here, and he's alert. Yeah, bitch.
Now you're mine.
Oh, man, are you kidding? Yeah, see, I can't do the third-person shooting very well. Because it's off to the right a little bit. I always forget. Oh, over the side, dramatic kill. Now I gotta go find the port. Now I gotta find the corpse. But that's okay. That's okay. I killed his ass. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. So now you know why I don't shoot in third person, because the targeting, the actual reticle is not quite accurate. It's off just a little bit. Yeah, I'm taking all those. You can keep your damn bone swords, dude. I don't give a shit about that. What I want is that bow. Because the Forsworn bow, if you're an archer in this game and you don't want to have to skill up all your crafting, the Forsworn bow is your best brigand friend. Your best friend. Because it is the biggest bow... Headdress. It is the biggest bow you can enhance with just steel. All you need is a steel ingot for it. Okay, we got those. Yes, good. Leather armor. I gotta sell those things. Okay. But it is the biggest bow that you can do with just steel. So you don't have to sit there and, you know, buy elven and orcish and whatever. It only weighs 11 pounds. The chicken's like, ooh, I am presenting. What? No! Nasty! And here you are. Crashing down the bushes, buddy. Now, see, now the problem is I'm going to get cocky, right? Because I'm like, oh, I can totally take these guys. It's like, yeah, you can't take a Briarheart, son. There's no taking a Briarheart. Not with iron arrows. But see that? Look at that bad boy. 11 pounds, 33 damage, right? And mine currently is 7 pounds and 22. But the Forsworn bow, like I said, is only 11 pounds. It looks cool as hell, too. It's just a cool-looking bow. Iron arrow, Forsworn arrow. I'll take those to sell at some future point. I don't care. Okay, so we got all that crap, right? And... So now you need to go back up, right? I need to go back Yeah, let's just go back up. Let's just run. What the hell with it. Maybe we'll see something interesting on the way. But if you're, like I said, if you're an archer and you like to play sneaky archers and you don't want to spend a lot of points on smithing, at least at first, and you want a quick drawing bow, Forsworn bow is it is the sweet spot. It is magic. It is hanging moss. Hello. And then somewhere over here, right? Yes, hanging moss everywhere here. Can't imagine what this place must smell like. The humidity, they have moss growing right up trees. Ugh. Must smell like an armpit up here. A juniper flavored armpit. Yeah, man, love me some Forsworn bow. Eventually I'll come down here and just harvest, just farm these guys to get the bows and just throw them in a chest. Skeleton in a big cave? I mean, there's the Draugr at the Bleak Falls Barrow. Skeletons? I don't remember there's skeletons here early on. Of course, if you just went wandering, who knows where you would have ended up, right? Hello, Khajiit. Khajiit has words if you have coin.
Do you seek to make a purchase? Take a look.
Take a look. I will take a look. And you have 798 gold. So let me sell some of this crap that I made. Yeah, I'll sell that. I don't need any of this stuff. Miscellaneous. Or ingots, yeah, I'm not selling any of that, dude. We'll sell some chicken breasts, maybe you'll like that. Forsworn. Leather helmet, fine. Yeah, I'll sell that. I'm not gonna do anything with that. Those are worthless. Okay, dude, what have you got? What have you got? You have anything for purchase? Because you have wares. Conjuring. Necklace of sneaking, 3,100. Nah, it's too expensive. Bows of torpor, weariness, don't need any of that crap because I got my Forsworn bow. Thanks, Rasad. See you later, man. May my road lead me to warm sands. Yes, it will. But first, we're going to go to Dawnstar, Snowberry capital of the north.
Trouble?
Nope, no trouble. We're fine, man. Everything's cool. Also, the Forsworn Conspiracy, if you ever get the chance and you play this game, run that with a conjurer, dude. You want to talk about easy mode, man? Running the Forsworn Conspiracy with a conjurer, dude, is like, it's laughably fast. I'm like, yeah. Outside the first village, the mine. Okay. Oh, hey, Mona Mead Levi, how you doing, Liz? It's going pretty good. You've come along at the end of the stream. I'm going to show him one more thing, and then I'm going to call it. But hey, how you doing? We're doing some Skyrim now. Outside the first village. Yeah, I'm trying to remember. I haven't played this game in like a year. Almost a year. What? Come on, man. Give me that. I'm going to hurry it up, dude. Relax. I paid you, dude. You work for me. You're my taxi. Tamriel's Uber. Okay, now we're gonna go to Dawnstar, and we're loyal to Dawnstar. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, so here's the second chest, Russell, in case you don't know where this is, or anybody else doesn't know where this is. It's a cheese ball way, but if you want to just get some quick money and you don't have any moral or ethical problems stealing from merchants, we can do this. Oh, wait. Ooh. Got to pan out. There we go. And we're loyal to Dawnstar, right?
Divine sake, Skald. Who do you think we're threatening with our old war room?
I mostly deal with petty thievery and drunken brawls.
Your man Horik is wearing his old Legion armor. What should I make of that?
He's proud of his service, Skald. The Legion taught us loyalty, and we're loyal to Dawnstar.
Loyal to Dawnstar. Thanks, Desdemona. He ain't no Tinker Tom. Okay, so here's the first mine, right? You come down the main street, you go past the first mine, and then you crouch over here by these trees, and there's a group of rocks, these three rocks right here. And in the junction of these rocks is a chest. And in this chest is a ton of shit. So here's the other chest. And 750 gold. That's how you can tell it's reset when the gold's back. So, yeah, if you want to be a cheese ball and get filled soul gems, money, and all kinds of potions, and just crafting stuff, and magical crap, and just anything, this is the other chest I know of. So, Yeah, if you want to cheese ball it, dude, you totally can. For now, however, we are at 306.
You should talk to Rusty.
And I'm pretty much tapped out. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do our normal. Oh, she's walking away from my with my light. Oh, don't do that. Okay, so we're gonna scroll back. So let's do this here. Let's get all fancy and take off my helmet and whatnot. So yeah, where's my helmet? Okay. So here we are. Here's our tribal Forsworn wannabe here. I want to thank y'all for watching. If you like the stream, if you like watching me play Skyrim and you want to see more Skyrim, go ahead and hit that like button. I'm probably going to continue because I had forgotten how much I absolutely love this game. if you're new to the channel and you like this kind of stuff, you want to see more, go ahead and hit subscribe and you will see more. I'm currently streaming 2 a week and I'm going to be trying to get back into produced videos once I figure out what the hell I'm going to be doing. I want to thank you all for sharing your Tuesday night with me. I want to wish Sin City Boy another happy birthday again. Happy early birthday, dude. I hope it's an awesome one. Hope you have a great weekend. And I will see you all in the next one. Take care, everybody.